Done. All the social media set up and software testing is complete. Electronic payment system's ready. It's all working, Julian. We're a go, buddy.
Fucking way, Buzz. You know what? You are the fucking man, buddy.
Oh, I know I'm the fucking man. I mean, I honestly don't think there's a snowball's chance of fucking hell this business is gonna work, but I did my best. Here we go.
That happens. My pistol and my rifle.
Man, looking on lowdown.
We out there. We out there at another Skinwalker Gang Yakov stream with the boys. It's Halloween 2023, baby. It's Halloween day. We're there. We made it. It's today. Are you guys afraid yet?
Let me be quite honest. I'm feeling a little spooked.
If I were you, I'd shit my pants preemptively so that you're all cleared out and ready to be afraid. Hell yeah.
Yeah, dude. Nah, I was going to go Halo mode on the fucking Skinwalker deer that you were just talking about a second ago.
Hey.
I will simply say to him, gang, gang, and he will give me candy. That's how this works, I think, dude.
What kind of candy would a skinwalker actually give you?
Yeah, what do they carry?
They probably give you like pennies. Like a pack of crayons and like a penny. So I am here with the boys. We got Flame Upon Herb on tap.
Greetings.
Ah! Jack is here. That was spooky. Jack's here.
What's up?
The boy Polak is here. That boy ain't right. We got Kay here with us. Live. And our boy Gonsfeld is here. What's up, dude?
I hate gnomes. I hate them. They're in my walls.
I'm gonna stand them for now.
Seinfeld is here.
Stand the gnome.
So I do have a very spooky special lined up for you people. Where to begin? I'm thinking to myself, it's like it's Halloween. We do spooky, but I'm like, no. We must make the schizo a priority over the spooky this season. Alright? So I think we do have a movie night for the people. A movie that I'm sure you haven't seen unless I've shown it to you. Schizophreniac, the Horror Mangler. From 1997. So before we get into that, what are we drinking, boys? I got this fucking... I got this pumpkin Jack cider that I'm sipping on for the season. I don't want to go overboard on pumpkin. That would be a mistake. You'll regret it. I'm having one pumpkin thing, then I'm switching to Old Milwaukee. How you guys partying?
I got a wonderful, wonderful, nice wild cherry Pepsi mixed with brown rum. So
delicious.
Got this saison.
Hell is that? It's like a beer.
Beyond the gnome world, man.
The gnome beyond world. The gnome
world. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
Beyond the gnome world. The Lemuria.
We're going back.
The gnome world. The gnome world.
Beyond Antarctica, man.
So where do they keep the UFO?
We do have a clusterfuck of a panel for tonight. I'm going to let whoever the fuck join who wants to join. It is Halloween after all. And this is Bacardi. My party, I guess. Bacardi at the party, dude. You never leave
Arizona,
home without it. Never drive
Arizona.
Without it.
Oh, yeah.
Kay's got the hood classic Arizona over there.
Yeah, Bacardi in Arizona.
So, guys, what's the most fucked up movie you've ever seen?
Schizophrenia.
Yeah, probably when y'all were watching bits and pieces of it, I popped in. Like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
I think on like a psychological level, probably Antichrist, but it's not that violent. It's just like, you see a guy's cock get destroyed in a woman's.
Oh, there was an animal movie we watched that had a brutal fucking.
Now,
what was it?
I had to edit Schizophreniac to be able to show it to you good people on these streaming platforms, and even that's a little dicey. We'll see. But the one thing I did have to get rid of is the close-up of a chopped-off penis. So I have seen penises get destroyed. I had to deprive you guys of the close-up grotesque shot of that tonight, I think, though.
Never forget what they took from you.
Schizophreniac it's part of a trilogy. Schizophreniac the Horror Mangler, followed by Schizophreniac Necromaniac, followed by the Cuckoo Clocks of Hell. The second one, it might be the best, but also while I'm thinking about it, there's like no way I could even edit that shit to show it to people. Whores! Kill the wild and all the whores! You guys are gonna love it, and maybe we'll just jump right into that. We'll make these fucking Dracula noises go away. Why is this crap even playing, dude? Goodbye, Dracula sounds. It's time for a world of schizophrenia with Schizophreniac. Is everybody watching?
Oh, yeah.
All right, and feel free to kind of talk over it. I don't really give a fuck that much because the plot is kind of speaks for itself, as it were. And if you're out there in chat, make sure you give me a whoop whoop. Tell me how you're feeling. Tell me if this movie offends your sensibilities, maybe. We have adult content, nudity, violence, propane language, dude. Propane.
Hank Hill's in this?
Yeah. Hank Hill.
Thank you.
How do you know it's a banger?
That boy Harry Russo ain't right. In memory of Harold J. Atkins.
Imagine this being like your memory.
We'll miss you. I think that's the director's father.
Okay.
I don't remember any of the names. Not important. Imagine we'll how your dad.
Yeah, this is how you're immortalized. This is your memorial.
Yeah, it is crazy, but I love it. God, if only that were me.
No, you're no fucking help, brother. Man. I got this fifth doing a week. I could be dead in a fucking week.
A Ron Atkins film, so you can blame this guy.
Kind of looks like every factory practice.
Right? How is this shit coming from you? I got a fucking movie to do with you, goddammit.
I've already missed like the sleeve of tattoo. But the stimulant use is there.
This guy sells like sports art now?
Yeah, he's a sports artist. I sent him an email. I would like to interview him. Schizophreniac, the whore mangler.
Is this movie part of the canon of the Manosphere?
I don't know what that means.
With the, you know, with the, you know, the goat artist. I don't know how to describe Manosphere.
I don't think
we were
so.
We talking about that a couple weeks ago. We're a little Tabasco and all that.
Crazy!
This is our boy Harry Russo. The one thing I did have to edit from this movie was the opening rape scene. So yeah, he's a rapist.
Harry's the name. And going nuts is the fucking game. Yeah.
I'm guessing he also wrote it. Did he also write it?
He has. He's credited as a co-writer, I think.
9 PM.
Awesome.
Huh?
You know when you make yourself the main character rapist of a movie, it's going to be a good movie.
I think Ron Atkins is the guy mostly to blame.
Okay.
Our boy John Gian Caspero or whatever his name is playing Harry Russo, partially to blame, but I love him for it. The most literally me character ever put to film. I might want to take that back by the end of this.
Yeah.
Harry Russo, age 28, occupation, low-budget filmmaker. Harry is a man on the edge of sanity due to his drug habit and his paranoid delusions of his girlfriend Drew not being loyal to him. But things are about to even get worse as Harry falls deeper and deeper into the hands of his friend. He calls.
Who hasn't pissed on the side of a building?
Rubberneck. We pissing, dog.
In like England, they just piss on the side of buildings. There's like anti-piss signs.
I think that designated cup was full pissing. Of piss and he loves it.
Designated pissing street.
So this is 1997. The drip reflects that. There we see Rubberneck for the first time. Score composed by Ron Atkins. Damn, drugs procured by Ron Atkins.
I like how that's like a vital part of the equipment necessary for the movie.
Whole movie, the whole series really is done in Las Vegas. Harry is very much a New Yorker, I believe.
He's a courier from Fallout New Vegas. Standard flow through.
It's fucking green, you motherfucker!
It's just the homies filming in the car, really. It's awesome. It's a better time.
This is me when I'm driving,
This is classic.
Anybody home? No, now!
Just being mean to people in public is just part of the course here.
Is he eating like a Slim Jim or something?
Hell yeah.
Looks like it,
I'm ready now. Let me get a sweet shirt.
What?
What are you, out of hearing? You got Big Mac?
No, but that's McDonald's. That's across the street. You have to go across the street to get those Big Macs, sir.
I thought this was the place.
This is
Wendy's,
Big Macs or McDonald's.
Who are you talking to? This is the fucking
fight! Dude, miss the old days when it was like an event. You get have like a camcorder and you go around with your boys just causing fucking problems. Now everyone's got a camera, it's ruined.
Damn, that's a long ass cigarette. Holy shit.
How you get shot for doing that shit?
It's called a Newport 100, dog. Yeah, you get shot.
Everyone
shot over in Newport 100 these days.
Marlboro Ridge.
Hey, baby, what's up?
Cowboy killers.
You fucking hard.
Yeah, well.
What the fuck?
Give this man an Oscar.
Look at him go.
A man with, or either a targeted individual or a man with schizophrenia told me about this movie. One or the other.
Could be both.
It's both.
He's digging for gold.
Gary? My man. Seem all wound up, Gary.
I'm always wound up.
I believe this is supposed to be his therapist.
Oh, I thought that was his dad.
It's hard to, they don't really make it clear, to be honest, and it's clearly they just knew a guy, and like, hey, we need a guy for a movie, and like, yeah, I'll do it. I thought about cutting out, like, this whole part, but it, I thought better of it in the end.
You gotta learn to calm down, Harry.
Huh?
Take one of these.
Right.
I know how you like drugs, Harry.
Hell yeah.
Yep.
So that's Sam Hyde, his therapist?
Yeah, I remember we were saying that the first time.
He does look like Sam Hyde.
Always. I have to. Let me see. Where did we leave off, Harry? You and Rick were here, and we were discussing your girlfriend?
Yeah, Drew.
Drew.
Right, Rubberneck, Drew?
Now, is Drew the, cause of the voices, you think?
No, well, yeah. She brought home the dummy in the first place.
She's a hooter.
Is that damn Harry?
One goal is going to be to try to figure out what her accent is, because I think it might be deaf. You fucking whore.
Fuck up, bitch. Fuck you listening to. I don't want to listen to this shit. I want to watch some fucking television, alright?
Alright, baby. Whatever you like. How was your day?
My day was just fucking great. Thanks for asking.
You're welcome. Harry?
What? Can't you see him doing lines?
What's the matter with you, dog? You're on a binge, aren't you? You've been going out on a binge.
I want to know if these are actual drugs that they're showing in this movie. I feel like it is.
Hook me up with some shit.
I do too.
I don't know.
I don't know.
But he's wasting a lot of it.
You want some big star to find you? Why the hell do I do this shit with you? Oh, when's it gonna stop?
Oh.
was good stuff.
Harry!
What is that? What is that accent?
What?
You got a little bit of retard in it.
Yeah.
Is that like Mama JF syndrome?
Yeah, Rubberneck, that movie Rubberneck.
Mama JF syndrome.
I got something special for you.
Oh, yeah, what?
Makes you feel good.
Yeah, I hope so too.
You know he knows you like all those movies, right?
Yeah, those Rubberneck movies, they're silly.
Fucking movies, for sure.
Oh, shit!
Yeah, for you.
Hey, Rubberneck.
You like him?
I love him.
Good.
Thanks a lot, sweetheart.
You're welcome.
How the fuck did you get your hands on this? What, are you fucking this guy or something?
No,
he ain't
no.
just gonna give you this dummy just for no reason.
Yes, he knows you like the movies, and I like you. I just thought maybe you needed a break.
But you need a fucking break. And I do like him.
Two.
Thanks.
Thanks.
So tell me how you got him.
He knows you liked the movie. He wanted you to have it.
Yeah, what'd you have to give him?
This is our protagonist, by the way.
Well, you know what? If you were more of a man,
I think I cut out some pussy eating right there.
What? You want satisfying facts? I'll give you satisfaction, guaranteed.
I like the dark, like style music going on.
Fuck you.
The
fuck you,
Cherry. Fuck me. Yeah, you wish you could fuck me.
It's like Skyrim dungeon music.
That must
really
be
is, yeah.
Yeah.
Just dungeon ambience, yeah.
About the dragon, about the mountain on the ground.
I'll fucking ruin that bitch. Oh Lord and Jesus.
What would you do, Harry, if she actually did make love to somebody else?
What? I'd fucking cut her neck off her head out of here.
Smooth off. Hell yeah, dude. Think I gotta edit that, dude? It's not that real. It's not real, I swear.
You know,
it looks like a fucking.
Who you calling dummy, dummy?
All right. I just,
I knew there was a reason why I liked coming here.
I am a dummy.
Sometimes you catch me even off guard. After that kind of talk, I need a hit.
Really can't unsee this damn hide thing now.
No, like
you think that's bad? You fucking look at Harry Russo and imagine nostalgia critic.
What kind of drugs have you?
Oh.
Oh, that'll really fuck it up.
Smoke up. Fuck up.
He looks just like the fucking
destroyer. Or after you get
robbed.
A little before and a lot after. That ought to tell you something.
He almost looks like he wants to talk, Harry. What does he want
now
to
we
say?
Just need an AVGN look a lot.
Wants to say, kill that fucking doctor. Kill Drew, and it'll just be me and you, Harry.
Kill Harry? He's never said kill before.
Kill. He wants me to kill Drew. He tells me that she's fucking blowing some other guy for his debt.
Blowing some other
guy. I believe him.
No, he says
believe,
it.
You believe the dummy?
I believe the dummy.
Blowing.
Sure this is not your alter ego speaking, Harry?
Alter schmalter. This fucking silly little freak.
And only you can hear him, though.
Only I can hear him. You can't hear him. To you, he's just a movie prop dummy.
Kay, is this some sort of MK Ultra thing? This whole movie?
This girl. Oh yeah. Oh hell yeah.
Bitch.
Yeah, probably. Right, I feel like it is. Or at least the funding.
Funding.
For the drug.
Funding. The camera. And a synthesizer.
Yeah, the drug money.
Before it was Drew that you were hearing all the time.
Yeah, but they also bought probably like $400 in cocaine.
They hired hulas.
Yeah.
Did he try to sell this movie to anyone?
I mean, I have no evidence of that ever happening.
You just put it. You just put it somewhere. Like there was no internet in 1997.
Dog, real talk. I had to set these up on my torrent downloader and let them sit there for fucking 2 years before they actually got enough cedars to finish the fucking movie.
Never mentioned the
Wow.
Now, that's insane. Now you can look up Schizophreniac Trilogy Archive, and it's on archive.com, so you can find it.
Hell yeah.
And like I said, this was shown to me by a schizophrenic person who like swore it was about their life, I think that was their bit.
You're such a stupid son of a bitch, Harry. Listen to me. It's me, Rubberneck.
Just say something. You tell me. What the fuck? Can't be. You just say something?
What do you mean did I just say something? You heard me, you cocksucker. Now listen to what I have to say.
No, sometimes I think it'd be entertaining to be schizophrenic.
As he cocks a gun.
Yeah. Actually, I didn't cock a gun. I don't know who's cocking.
This is gonna be King Cobra and his dummy soon.
This holy shit! Anyway, Harry, you he is going down this arc. What crime do you think Cobes will get arrested for?
Sicko shit, probably. You don't.
Here's some like 4chan got arrested for fucking his mom, like so I wonder what Cobes will do.
I know your bitch whore cunt's been fucking that asshole Frank Brigette, and you better kill them both now, Harry. Now.
You think he actually controls you, Harry?
Yeah, because I do what he says.
Gotta.
Why in the world would you do what an inanimate?
Who's stoned for this?
He's a laminate object. He's made out of plywood.
Because I like doing what he says. He tells me to do
laminated us.
It's an inanimate, right? I'm not tripping.
Inanimate.
Inanimate object. Inanimate object.
God, I miss 90s like shit ass room decor.
You're going over the deep end or something.
You hear what he's saying, Lumpenek? I don't agree with it either.
I had one of those shitty couches just like that, Manon.
What are you trying to say, Doc?
I don't know. I think you should and loosen up a little bit, Harry. You know? You've got a lot to unload, but I think you ought to try and loosen up.
Speaking of unloading, I think I'm going to go unload in your bathroom.
Oh, not again, Harry.
Oh, yeah.
I knew he was going to say that.
A little bit of editing magic here happening, I think.
You wanna calm me down, Dr. Brown? You fucking think you know what I need?
Know what I need?
Cut you like
hoo-ha.
A fucking pig. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck? The dungeon music for that.
Cut your belly open. Yeah. And see all the black stuff you got in there. Yes. Yes. Oh. You remember the motherfucking think you can fucking tell me what to do and how to fucking live?
Harry fucking Russo.
Tell
me
nothing but Rubberneck.
Yeah, it's a cut.
It's like, holy shit, this is like a fucking...
He's like Eltry, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he's acting mind like Volcal on the internet. Yeah.
Come to Baba.
Beautiful.
Fucking cough him like a pizza!
Oh, this shit is legit spooky, too. You show this without context, it could totally be like some snuff film bullshit. Oh, so realistic. Amazing effects right there, dude.
The death of Sam Hyde.
The death of Sam Hyde.
The rise of the nostalgia critic. Of right. Doug Walker, his origin story.
Sam, use your power level.
What do you think they're cutting right there? Is that a piece of meat? They put some t-shirt over?
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
Yeah. Looks like a beef. Yeah.
Hell yeah. I think we need another shot of that. One more shot of that.
One more shot of
that. Keep fucking coming in.
Yeah, keep knife fucking that meat.
The meat OC.
The beef OC.
The beef OC. No, somehow been defeated. What the fuck? It's
fucking content. Rain, man. It's always gotta fucking rain. Every day it's rain. Rain, rain, rain. Fucking rain. Fucking rain.
To know an autistic guy that walked like him.
Yeah. Oh, we got the funky bass playing. Rain.
That dude does not know how to play that fucking thing.
No,
it's all good, bro. Just give me the fucking shit and take whatever's there. Oh shit.
I like these.
Go ahead, buddy.
So, we'll see you tomorrow, man?
You bet your sweet ass, big boy.
He's Naruto running.
Hell yeah. This dude loves heroin. You don't understand. Like nobody before him has ever loved heroin. I think I did cut out the injection here. Hell. That's another thing about this. There's so many things in this movie that are like gif-able to make into like memes and shit, but nobody even found
them. Yeah,
like
that. A
lot of reaction.
Yeah.
Reaction images, yeah. Yeah, like that. You play like Wendy's double meat cheeseburger got me lost.
Oh, fuck.
This is how Elvis died.
He went here and went on the shitter.
I thought he shat himself. Yeah.
He shat the opiate shot. I guess he had like an opiate turd built up so big.
That's true.
Fatal shit, dude.
Fatal shit, yeah. Fatal. He's like a fat guy too, so he probably took some horrible opiate shits.
You know, my father left my mother when we were little.
My father.
She was nothing but a fucking whore. So why did we have to pay bills?
Hooah.
My father said I'd never be much of a man anyway. They didn't want me. They always wanted a girl.
A girl.
Before my father left my mother, I killed him.
Still a better actor than James Rolfe.
My father was gone. It was all downhill.
James Rolfe becomes a meth addict and makes you destructive. Best timeline.
That girl my mother always wanted turned out to be me.
I'm a goyle.
She used to put me in dresses.
Instead of the angry video game nerd, it's the angry Vicodin game nerd.
It's just fucking humiliating.
Huh?
He's literally Buffalo Bill from the Silence of the Lambs.
Yeah.
People wonder why I am the way I am.
Yes, basically. This was 97, like I said, so I don't know. Do math on that one. I don't know when that came out, when it got popular.
I think it was in the 90s. When this dude's like a transsexual murderer.
Whores.
Whores.
I hate dogs even more. Just men that want to be women. It's all fucking anybody's good for. It's taking it up the fucking ass. Yep. Just a little girl.
I'm Goyle now.
Against her will. You know what that's like?
This is the Masanichi Temple.
They don't know the pain. They're all out there in their fantasy worlds, living their fucking fairy tales, playing the game of life. Look at me. Playing shoots and fucking ladder.
What?
That's why I know how to treat these women today. Kill them. Fuck him up the
face.
I don't know what I've seen.
There's a gift.
Fucking music sting.
Come face to face with the devil. And he called me a girl. That's all anybody's ever
been for. The devil shivers.
It's for fucking up the ass. The sooner you know that, the better you are. Don't ever let anybody tell you different. Now let's go to work. Kill some dumb hoo-ha bitch.
He does make sense sometimes.
It's gonna be a good fucking
he
night.
He does look like a nostalgia critic. Even that hat.
We're heading into the heaviest editing in the video.
Was,
let me know if anything pops out that shouldn't be there.
Those pigs, they make me sick, all of them, and their mothers.
Like, fucked up, they left in a booby.
All I know is that whoever we fucking get, she better show you some respect, doll or no doll. You're no fucking doll to me. Fuck that shit. Hey, how's it going? What's up, street douche?
Street douche.
What's up, sweetheart? Hey, babe, how about a date tonight? What kind of date are we talking about? What the fuck? I gotta take out to dinner right now?
No, $50 gets your blowjob, and $100 you can do anything you'd like to me.
Oh, yeah, anything?
Yes.
I'm a little short on cash right now, so how about I just give you some crack, all right?
Sure, babe, I'd love to get high with you.
All right, I'll get you high, low, all over the place. Out of here. Get in the fucking car. Let's do this.
Let's go, Hua. You too, street douche.
You get in the back.
We're going to vote for Joe Biden. His son loves crack.
It's done. A... This is just Hunter Biden.
This is what really went down, man.
Yeah.
What an asshole.
Fucking hate street douche. Fuck that guy.
Fuck street douche, all my homies hate street douche.
So baby, what is your name?
Harry. You know, like I got a fucking hairy ass. What the fuck is your name?
Anything you want me to be, baby. If it's Bambi, I'll bounce off the fucking walls for ya.
Fuck Bambi. And the only thing bouncing in this car is gonna be my fucking balls on your fucking chin, alright? I think I like fucking whore. Right? When I say fucking whore, you say what?
What? What the fuck are you on with the shit you talking about? I came here to do something, man. Let's just get down to it.
Don't worry about what the fuck I'm on, alright? Because I know what you're gonna be on in a minute. Now just show me your fucking tits.
So what do you think about these, baby?
Hell no. Hot enough for YouTube.
That was that weird kind of bad acting where it's like too emotional.
Yeah. It's uncomfortable.
Yeah. Baby.
Oh, no, baby.
Like, she seems genuinely distressed.
Sounds good. What's it?
She's probably a real whore. They paid to do this.
Just found some random whore on the corner. Yeah.
Oh, shut up. Shut the fuck up, rubber neck. Shut the fuck up.
No boobies.
Oh no.
Am I allowed to show this on the internet? I'm not.
No.
Can I?
No.
That's ridiculous.
Come on, I cut it all out, dude.
Bro's just doing some push-ups, right?
Yeah, you can turn that into a GIF, but that would be like.
Everything's fine.
It's that fucking hairy ass I was talking about. Hey, Robin, Nick.
Jesus! Spooky, dude. Legit spooky. A crack for ya.
Wait, didn't he already kill her?
Yeah.
We're getting the job done. We get the goddamn job done. Bum fights.
Dude. I was like, did you do it, Sally?
It's possible. It's possible. I went through it clip by clip, and it definitely looks like it, but I couldn't find it in the actual frames. Maybe. Might have seen it.
Yeah, the guy's supposed
to be. Might have seen it.
This whole movie seems like it was directed by the guy who made Bum Fights.
Yeah, no, it feels like Bum Fights, feels like CKY, feels like all those like tape things, Backyard Wrestling, feels like all that stuff.
Yeah.
There's so many like gif-able moments.
Yeah. It's wonderful, and I'll tell you, the second one is even more so. Oh man! Literally me when I have to go to work.
This is the last time I drink rubbing alcohol.
Anybody coming?
That boy from the neighborhood, Harry Russo.
Oh, thank you, Harry.
You're welcome.
I wanna fuck you, Miss Parker.
You're welcome. What? That was like a Sam Hyde bit.
Dude, this is like the vibe that gave birth to all these things, I think, that we enjoy now.
Yeah. A lot of us expected East Coast guy with glasses.
Yeah. He's like definitely in New York. His Facebook says he's like in New York City and everything. He's a New Yorker.
Ooh, woo. Where's Sam Hyde from?
Massachusetts.
What's the like tiny state? Come on,
I'll be across the street. I don't know. Rhode Island. Is that where he's from? He's one of those states.
Over at that restaurant. One of those.
Huh?
Rhode Island.
I don't know. Maybe. He's definitely a New Englander.
Like, Sam Hyde is making fun of what this guy is, like, genuinely fucking acting like. But with really bad acting. Just, like, he was like a bit. Not really a bit. Maybe it's a bit. It's not a bit.
What is going on? Why is this guy like making such a big face? Is he shitting or throwing up?
It's whatever you want it to be. It looks delicious though, some minestrone. I'm a Goyle. The devil said I was a Goyle.
Fuck. Can't you see the real me? You wanna lick me? You wanna fuck? You want some of this? You want some action, baby? I'll give you action.
This is what the media wants you to be. They want you to be Harry Russo. Once everyone's Harry Russo, then they can weaponize all the police departments. They can fucking go full New World Order, dude. Martial law.
Oh, this is... They're just gonna, release
baby.
This guy. That's the tactic.
Fucked up.
You get enough of these people, then you can, release them on Hamas. That's, the secret weapon.
Army of schizo trannies.
Yeah, they're just gonna let him go on him off. He'll die of cringe.
It's freaky, dude. This is freaky shit, honestly.
This is like getting up there.
This is supposed to be funny.
Oh, this is a gifable thing.
Oh yeah.
Up there, hated bro's got some moves.
Yeah.
The coke will do that to you. Hide bit right here.
Yeah, that's how it's hard.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
Yeah.
Die!
Like what he's doing in the gym, but he's like going out at everything.
Kill the world! Kill the world!
Gonna get you! You're gonna die! Ooh.
Ooh. Like, this is a perfect gift.
Join your fucking bed, you cunt!
What the fuck?
Open that door already! Open that door already! Jesus!
He's like a main character in a video game. Where have you been? Jumping around.
He's the ultimate main character. The world exists to serve Harry Russo.
Waiting at home for you. What the hell did you do? Come here, Stone? Look at this.
Yeah, that's right.
I take your shit. God. Fuck to do with you.
Let me give it to you. It's not me. It's the dummy. It's like he's inside my head telling me what the fuck to do. That's why I had to leave the fucking silly little bastard in the car. Think of his fucking voice.
It's a dummy. It's a prop, man. It's just nothing but crazy. You're the one that's crazy. You're nuts. The fucking dog.
Yeah, that's why he told me you did fuck Brigitte, right?
Why is this bitch's accent changing every
time? If I did, maybe it's because I need to go somewhere else. You're not a man to me anymore.
I think she's deaf or some shit.
She's like deaf and Cajun or some shit like that.
I'm telling you, it's the fucking dummy
rubbing there.
It's like that guy I was listening to who was retarded and Australian.
There is no way. Yeah.
Save me, Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Velvet Jesus, please help me. I need you to talk to me. I'm hearing negative voices. To hear a positive one, Velvet Jesus, please. I think Rubberneck's the devil. He tells me bad things. I need you to talk to me, Velvet Jesus. Please. Just give me a sign, Velvet Jesus. Anything. Please. Uh-oh. It's Jesus, you're the best.
These are the moments I just zoomed in because I couldn't really censor things.
Too much going on.
Ding dong, the bitch is dead.
You're not allowed to see this.
Bitch is dead. Bitch is dead. Ding dong.
Breakdown.
He's really going.
He's fucking juking and jiving.
He's toss that dancing. Holy shit. Video game punch sound.
Yeah, it's great. It's the Minecraft sound effect.
Me when my pickaxe breaks and I need to mine the stone by hand.
I told you I was gonna kill you and fuck you, right? Yeah. Big daddy.
YouTube safe? Cut.
What the hell are you doing here?
I'm gonna be in Vegas. There was like this little of anything to do about Vegas.
Well, it's in the desert. You can tell it's the desert.
He's like Bay Area thrash guy.
Show the fucking... I don't know.
Bay Area thrash
trip or anything.
Yeah, you're right.
We're gonna start playing some Bay Area thrash.
We live right now?
Hell yeah, we're live watching Schizophreniac. Tune in, brother.
Oh shit. I'll have to disconnect and reconnect after my computer boots.
I don't care, do it.
Hell yeah.
Fucking like, bro. It's just like
this
me.
Is a, like high quality version, bro. What the fuck?
Yeah, dude, we only get the best here on fucking
hey,
Skinwalker
hey,
Gang.
Hey,
it's fucking 4K.
Yeah. You can see all his pores just like he can when he's on 10 fucking 10 strip of acid staring himself in the mirror.
I fucking need some money, man. Fucking hard up, man.
I don't need a radio.
Come on, man. Come on.
Dude.
Come on.
Come on.
I'm in a rush.
get out of here. $10, man. Sony, man. So what do you say, man? Come on, man.
They want a little foil.
Show me this fucking thing.
Damn, man.
Fucking ball up here.
$10 to Sony?
Check this motherfucker out, man. Oh, yes. It's a fucking sharp, not a Sony.
Yeah.
It's fucking high dollar. You're
pretty sharp yourself.
Damn right about that. Check that motherfucker out.
What the hell does that mean? You had 97 fucking boombox, dog. It's a hell of a deal.
I'll give you fucking $10. It's gonna be right here, right?
I'll be right
I'll
here.
Be right back with $10. Don't go nowhere.
Got it. Hey, Jack. You fucking have this back, baby.
Got $10. Woo! Harry fucking Russo.
Hey, Jack, you still taking a fucking piss over there, man, or what? Fuck. Christ, man. It's fucking radio,
how much
man.
Fun do you think he was having doing all this shit? Yeah, my man. God, dude.
He's in a great lab.
Wow, this is so epic.
Radio, man. fucking radio, man. Jesus, you fucking lunatic.
Yeah!
Gang stalking.
Fell in my piss.
Oh, this is the last time I drink Mad Dog 2020. You ever had that like gas station wine?
Hell yeah, dude. I was 18 once.
I used to live off like the blue raspberry one.
Yeah.
Drop me! Who the fuck are you, man?
Man?
Hey, you look kind of familiar. I know you. You're the guy with the little fucking dolly, aren't you? So where's your little buddy now, huh? What are you doing here, man? Huh? What makes you so special to come to my buddy?
I feel the same way, Harry. I feel the same way. I would choke that same fucking asshole.
Street douche?
Yeah, street douche. Is that what he's credited as?
No, this actually isn't street douche, but I'm assuming anybody can be a street douche, really.
He's asking for it.
You really gonna taunt the schizophrenic guys?
Yeah, like I said,
you're starting to piss me off! My buddy's over there, and he'll come around the corner and kick your fucking ass, you fucking bald-headed freak! Yeah, your friend's gone, but your dick's gonna be f***ed.
Yeah.
Why is it bleeped?
Because I had to edit this so I could put it on the internet. I want to put this on YouTube.
That makes sense.
Yeah, I bet you like my balls rubbing against your chin, you queer bitch.
A queer bitch is okay, because they call themselves queer.
Yeah, it's his word.
Why don't you come here?
Oh shit, I love how he pulled that shit out. He's like an elf about to fuck you up. I'm not sure this will be allowed, like that part will be allowed.
I know,
YouTube,
but there's like worse things on YouTube.
Yeah, way worse.
I know, I'm with you. I agree. I'm just saying.
You can't dox another YouTuber and go to his house because you're not a hot chick who makes YouTube millions of dollars in advertisement revenue.
Where did he get the revolver from?
Rubberneck.
He pulled it from his cock, bro. Yeah. Rubberneck appeared and he got it.
Rubberneck is the fed.
Yo, is this schizophrenic too?
No.
Fucking world, Rubberneck! I'll fucking kill all you motherfuckers!
Fucking
broad!
No, considering how much this DVD goes for, do you think there's a possibility you'll get copyright stricken?
No, I don't think it'll come up on any algorithm. I don't think they'll catch it.
Isn't this the guy who made it?
No, it's not.
Or is the other dude?
No. Settle down. Settle down, senor, with your irrelevant questions.
We stated that a man yesterday...
If the DVD's really expensive, that means, like, nobody watches it.
Exactly.
Right.
Ran out of the store yelling at the doll. Here is a police sketch of that man.
Oh, shit.
He drew that. That's the him? Guy playing Harry Russo drew that. He's a sports artist. All his stuff looks like that.
Or the whereabouts.
That's awesome. Interesting trivia.
Please call the FBI at 1-800-523-9112. And that is it. I am Jim Rhodes.
What if that's an actual phone number?
Let's give it a whirl.
Thank you.
Hey, someone give it a call.
Who's that?
It's not Velvet Jesus, that's for sure. Y'all remember 1997 when shit looked like this? Probably a little before that, like 93.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Sun.
What the fuck?
The sun just spoke to me. There's a farm outside. And cows.
There's cows.
Seems nice.
Seems tranquil.
All right, Mr. Sun, you keep shining, you yellow rat bastard.
Hell yeah.
Death cop.
In the scene prior to this, he pissed himself. I cut that part out, too.
Look at, I think that guy probably would have been allowed. Diaper chews allowed. He's not.
I hear you. You don't know anymore.
His old lady Parker. It's beautiful out. You fucking bitch! You keep it out there, you fucked!
Great day to kill the wild.
That's me anytime anybody's outside of my house.
Dumb fuck!
Oh. Every single time.
Shit. Oh, these fucking kids today! It's throbbing and swollen! Oh.
Damn, look at him sell that thumb.
I know.
Oh. Fucking thumb, man. I can't use it anymore!
Sucks.
I don't need this dumb. I don't need this shit. Stop hurting. Man.
Did he just put a cigarette out on his thumb? Is that what happened?
I think he did.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
His thumb was a cake the whole time.
Just like that.
It's literally just a rubber fake Halloween thumb from fucking Spirit Halloween. Like, I can show this on YouTube. Come on now.
I love how you could just see that he's like doing the Four Horsemen game time. I'm sorry for just coughing into a mic like an asshole. My bad.
That blood looks a little watery.
I think
it was cranberry juice.
I think they got some meat. They used meat to stab, and they like dumped out the blood from the meat.
The juice, yeah,
like that.
The mayo blood.
How's that sound?
Real farm boy knows that ain't blood.
Yes.
Wait, Rubberneck's gonna do some fucking? Is that what I caught?
Come on, move!
I love this shit. He's just being a menace in traffic.
It's literally me. Like, there's so many literally me moments.
I know. It's nonstop.
Nobody fucking gets in my way. If they do, I kill them.
It's like falling down, but more unhinged.
Yeah.
Just me. More me. That's all I need.
Yeah, my wife hasn't left me yet.
Right hand looks good. Mini theater.
What happened to porn theaters?
It's free now.
Oh goddamn it, I thought I changed my fucking. You guys still hear me, huh?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Oh baby. I'm coming to get you.
Daddy's coming to get you.
That's exactly how you're supposed to hold a baby.
Damn.
You don't know that, but that's what keeps them the safest.
Hold them like by their head, like a you pull them at like a
you
basketball.
Pick them up like the Great Khali.
Yeah. No, it's daylight. Notice like because he turns the fucking corner.
He's love been looking for a porn theater for 12 hours.
I love that they're like, oh, we can still do it. Like, it says that he's going crazy. You don't know what it really is. It's artistic.
When really, it's just they needed to do it when they had time.
Yeah.
Because they're working at, like, fucking McDonald's. So you're saying you wouldn't pay $8 or whatever to go into a weird, dark room with a bunch of other men to look at porn?
You're not allowed to jerk off,
the
so...
smell. Yeah, I know. Pee Wee Herman got arrested for that.
Alright, there's a part there I had to cut out where he walks in, there's like a mother holding her little baby, and he grabs the mom and throws her the fuck out while she's holding the baby, and the baby's recoiling in horror. You're gonna be right there with and while I'm sure she consented, I don't think she expected Harry Russo.
Why did she have a baby in a porn theater? I think that's a...
Well, they're not really at a porn theater.
I get that, but like...
I don't know. Look, dude. I'm trying to make sense of the plot. You're telling me there's a plot hole in Schizophreniac Whore Mangler?
You talking to me? What the fuck are you looking at? You never seen a pretty girl before?
You can tell he's about to crack up, like, every scene.
Yeah, this is where it stops being literally me.
And yet you can still see this on the world. It's still kind of relatable. It's like, yeah, this happens. Like, it's kind of...
Yeah, it happens. I see what you mean by it's relatable. And it's like, humans go through this. I haven't.
Yeah, I had to remove the audio for this scene. It was just nothing but sex noises playing. Yeah.
I love the fucking Benny Hinn music. I wish you'd sped it up. If you sped up Harry.
Benny Hill. Benny Hinn's a different guy.
Oh, is Benny... Which one?
Benny Hinn heals people on a stage for Jesus.
I thought that was Benny Hill. My bad.
Benny's mixed up.
Yeah, we got yakety sacks rolling and romping and stomping for this one, no doubt. Felt appropriate.
Had you just done this at like 2x speed, I think it would.
I know, I thought about it, but I want to keep the movie as much intact as I could.
No, that makes sense. You're a historian.
In the spirit of pure, pure.
Why is this guy dressed like Ricky from Trailer Park Boys? That's like, he looks like thin Ricky. It's fucked. You ever know what cut Harry Russo is? Like, dude,
he's a badass. He's a literal. I bet he's an actual crazy person. He is fucking ridiculous. Shut the fuck up! You can read lips there.
Yeah, I think I saw something about a pork and beef meatball that you might buy in the UK.
Nobody ruins my fucking fun!
Literally me. Once again, he is literally me.
Hell yeah, dude. What is that hunk of meat anyway?
It looks like a leg of some kind. Like a big old hunk of fat, like pork.
Yeah. He's okay.
You're fucking dead, you hooah!
You shot a hole into some meat.
You fucking disfigured piece of shit! Suck my dick, whore!
Isn't the guy who plays Harry Russo like a prolific fucking, I guess these are exploitation films, but like late exploitation films.
The, not him, the director.
But isn't he like an actor for a lot of those?
Who?
Like he's got like six or seven.
Dog, you look this guy up on IMDb. There's like nothing but schizophrenic, and that's it, basically.
There's another one where it was like from like 10 years ago.
Cuckoo Clocks of Hell. That's the third schizophrenic movie. Alright, whatever. It doesn't matter.
Some late breaking news: we have three dead in an adult theater on Sahara and Convention Center Drive near Market Street. We have Kim Jank alive on the scene. Let's go to Kim.
Kim Jankum.
Kim, can you tell us what's happening now?
Jankum.
At 5 a.m. this morning at the Triple X Theater,
she's
behind
a Jankum
me, a man by the name of Harry Russo committed the murders.
Oh fuck!
How do they know his name?
They're fucking onto his rubberneck. No, 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 fuck!
Kim, so you spoke with the manager. It sounds like a bloodbath down there. Awful.
Yes, Jim, I'm standing here with Miss Parker, Harry Russo's neighbor. Miss Parker, what type of man was Harry Russo?
Harry was a good boy. He always treated me good.
He's a good boy. He
about
didn't
a week
that.
Ago, a man was
he's
calling
trying
me
to
names and
his
cussing
life together.
Me. Harry went over to the man's car and started choking him.
I remember that motherfucker. I got him, Miss Parker.
If I hadn't stopped him, he would have killed the fella. The only thing I find weird about Harry is he kept carrying that doll around.
Well, thank you, Miss Parker. Well, Jim, you heard it here. With Kim Jinko reporting live.
Would you like a drink?
No, thank you, ma'am.
What an unfortunate situation, Kim. Thank you for that report. None of the victims' names have been released. We'll have more on the story at 6.
How'd they know it was Harry?
Because Miss Parker knew.
Oh, yeah. I'd imagine you already explained anytime you have this, it's just big, floppy Harry Russo dick.
Yup. It's true.
It almost looks like Vladimir Putin, but thing.
So that's what people don't know is this is Vladimir Putin's son.
It's Russian this propaganda.
Is yeah,
this is Vladimir Putin's backstory.
What the fuck? What a fucking dream. I'm so fucking real. Holy shit, boy, Jesus.
Jesus.
Velvet Jesus, where
the
are you?
What is this? Play me?
His thumb's back. Look, his thumb's back.
How you doing, Harry?
Hell Harry. Yeah.
By now you should be watching this video cassette. That only means one thing. We struck again. Who'd you kill this time? Another dumb bitch? You like fucking in the ass, you sick bastard. No! No fucking way! No, I didn't fucking kill anybody! No! Don't you fucking tell me I did that! Yeah, yeah, yeah! It's all true. They're all dead. Dr. Brown, Drew, some hooah, three fucks in a porno movie theater, some dumb bitch who broke into our house and knifed her up. No, 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 no! No! You know what the fuck I'm talking about. And don't fucking push out on me either. There's more to come. Just kill them all!
Average writer and follow up.
That's crazy, that way. It's crazy that while he was all fucked up, he fucking edited this tape that way.
It's impressive, if anything.
He's like, no, I'm gonna show myself what I feel. It's awesome.
No, I didn't do it!
Hell yeah.
Oh, shit.
That was like a grandpa bit.
Holy shit. Motherfucker! What the fuck do you think I'm on? Me? Are you? Fuck you!
Literally me to myself every day.
Holy shit! What the fuck's going on?
Hell yeah, we got Maud here.
Maud, schizophreniac, dude. What, schizophreniac?
Oh yeah. Oh,
you get the end of it.
No. Dead, you fucking idiot. I don't fucking need your shit anymore. I don't know what the fuck's real and what's not real. I ain't gonna fucking listen to you.
So me.
They were nothing but dirty whores, Harry. They deserve to die. What are you doing, Harry? Let me go. I told you the truth. Now let me go, Harry.
They're all
got
whores.
It all wrong, Harry.
Who
what do you think you're doing
I
with
love
that bag?
Dub.
That's to you, Harry.
Oh, please,
don't, Harry. Harry, let go of me, you son of a bitch, or they'll be held to pay.
Let go of me, you son of a bitch.
So good.
I told you the truth, Harry.
Fucker. Caused me a not fucking trouble.
Sounds like he's on a fucking tape recorder.
Yeah.
So good.
In the bathroom. In the closet.
They did the soundproofing right when they fucking cheaped out on the tape recorder, so they sound like shit.
Kill this! Kill him! Kill her! Fuck you, Robinette! Say goodnight!
Alright, so... Well, this reminds me of the time that I thought helicopters were fucking stalking my house, and I went out in my boxers, and I followed the helicopters.
Hell yeah.
To fucking kill whores with.
I go outside of my boxes all the time, like throw trash away and shit.
No, I walked probably about a mile to the public golf course and then circled the golf course and realized that I think they were doing training of some kind and then walked home. I was like, I am schizophrenic, I need to go home.
Channel 6 right in their ass. Jim Cunt Jekyll and Jim Dick fucking dead.
God, this
right
is
now
me.
We got bigger and better things to worry about, rubbing that.
Is my hair.
Well, why you got that cut,
never
bro?
Catch us.
It's natural, bro.
New Harry Russo.
Is your hairline that high up? Like you're wearing a wig the wrong way?
it just lays like that.
Drew.
It was all a dream.
Oh, I was still right. I was still right, that's cool. Oh no.
Children are you fucks? Your fucking kids are dead! Your fucking kids are dead! They're mine! It's just me!
Oh boy.
Israel will be like.
This is Benjamin Shapiro.
This is the INEF recording line. There we go.
John Gian Caspro.
These credits are awesome.
They're amazing.
Reminds me of Fat Albert.
Yeah.
So, like, how was this even done? Because it looks like it's typeface. Like, it doesn't look like it's hand-drawn.
Dude, this is some, like, mid-90s computer program.
That's crazy. This is, like, done Microsoft Word art. Like Windows 98 Microsoft Word art.
Ron Atkins. You thank him for this shit.
camera work, just general camera work. All the camera work is done by fucking John Atkins. And then Luther and Luther Lighting.
They did a terrible job. We'll give them that.
with the lighting guy, is it just Luther, or did he have a crew who it's Luther and Luther
it's
Lighting?
An old man and his son.
So he can't say, like, Luther and Luther's son? Like, he has his Luther's son is uncredited. He's just part of the corporation of Luther's Lighting. But Luther has to be credited.
Yeah.
Fucking love Luther.
Lighting? Lucifer?
Yeah, that's a good call. Illuminati, most definitely.
People don't.
Special thanks to Jamal for the use of his shop for filming.
Who's Jamal? And what was happening? Which scene was in his shop? That's the question.
I think the porno theater.
Probably.
That's my guess.
Man, that last shot hit me kind of hard because I got a kid.
Shots filmed with a minor, parent consent and extra care and precautions were taken. They swear to it.
That kid that can't consent.
Yeah. That's why I cut the baby out, because the baby couldn't fucking say they wanted to be yelled at by Harry Russo.
Yeah, that got me. That is like, Harry Russo, you son of a bitch.
Rubberneck was a real child the whole time that he was horribly abusing, apparently.
Good heel work.
So definitely MK Ultra movie? Oh, that's fucking dope.
Yeah.
MK Ultra movie confirmed. Human trafficking, satanic ritual abuse.
Yeah, that.
Trauma-based mind control, all present in this film. Schizophrenic, the horror modeler.
That's true.
Satanic
ritual
abuse.
When are we going to do Schizophrenic 2 Necromaniac?
Whenever I feel like editing it. I'll see how people take to that. I don't know how people will react to that. I know.
That is a chore.
It might be impossible, but I would try it.
If I remember correctly, the entire first scene is tits and then prostitutes being slaughtered. If I'm recalling...
I thought the first scene was him raping a nun.
Yeah, that is pretty much how it goes. Yeah, that's actually correct.
I don't remember the nun rape at all. I remember
it was buried in my mind. I have it burned.
I remember the hooers where he's like, you hooers want to have some fun? Oh shit, we camming it up.
She was a hooer. Yeah, it's a fucking Halloween party. Get the fuck on cam if you're getting on cam.
I'm fine. Jesus. Shit.
Oh man, I've got more lighting than this. That looks wonky with the extra light fucked out.
Kind
of
spooky. Kind of spooky. Actually,
definitely.
I'm genuinely not doing anything extra. There's just a light. One of the LEDs is like dimmer than the other. I have one that's full brightness over here, and then one that's dim, and it turned me sepia. That's cool.
Jack, what are your opinions on Schizophreniac?
kind of like when you were like 16 and you thought about maybe you saw American Psycho or some shit and you thought I could do that. That's like what would have happened.
Well, this is like me and my buddies would like Jackass just premiered or whatever. And one buddy has like a camcorder and one buddy has like a straitjacket and someone puts on the straitjacket and you do goofy fucking shit with the camcorder or like backyard wrestling. You're filming like
one buddy have a straitjacket. That's I've never.
I don't. I have no idea.
I couldn't
explain that. He had one. I couldn't explain why. I don't know. Probably a scary
scene. I've literally been in a fucking mental hospital and I've never seen a straitjacket in real life. Like that's crazy.
Yeah, it's interesting that he wanted to castrate people because he wanted to like castrate himself. That's like probably the biggest takeaway I can take from that.
He met the devil, and the devil called him a goyle.
A goyle.
The devil called
him. Now, my takeaway from that was the dude who plays Harry Russo is a legend,
a method actor.
Probably a meth addict.
He's a method actor.
That's wild.
That's
a really high quality version of the fucking file you found. Because did you I missed a lot of shit.
This was, I think, torrented. I believe the archive versions are shittier. Now, because these are cursed files, most definitely, Schizophreniac 2 is, like, corrupted as shit. And the longer it sits on my computer, the more corrupted it becomes. And it's fucked up, because the movie's fucked up itself. And you watch it, and you're like, I can't tell if this is glitching or if it's supposed to be this way. And really, it was, like, 50-50 once I found the archive version, which is, like, the complete version that's not all fucked up. But it's, like, lower quality, I guess. So that's probably the one I'll go with if I do this in the future.
Yeah, man. Like, every time I'm just, like, left agape at the fact...
They're gaping. You're over here gaping, dog. All right. Well,
that's not
anyway. Any final words on Schizophreniac, boys?
No.
Nothing.
It was my first time. Biden experience.
I wish it was real.
Dirt Wizard in the chat asks, is this the Netflix adaptation of The Life of Cobra JFS? Yeah. That's where we're going. He has Sean, the puppet, and he's that guy, Jeremy, I want to say, that guy who was living in his apartment for a week, that guy looked just like Harry Russo.
He did, holy shit.
So, back to that.
Butt crack on screen.
We got butt crack, dog. Yeah. Butt crack cam. Live butt crack cam.
Crack cam.
Dog, are you talking to us? We cannot hear what the fuck you were saying.
No.
Are you telling me that this fucking thing is actually what you can hear me from?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yes.
Why the fuck doesn't this mute it? You could still fucking hear me right now perfectly fine.
Yes.
Fucking button. This look, do you see the light?
Were you gonna say something?
No, just fucking it's spooky out because I heard tin cans rattling out. I went to check on it. And there's nobody there. I was like, maybe it was my wife putting shit in the recycle, and I went inside, and there's nobody there. So, like, there's a fucking... Wife's gone. Wife's gone.
Wife's gone, ghosts have arrived.
Yeah.
It is the spooky street.
It's the ghost of Mama Jaya.
Bro, I saw JF was commenting on Israel today, and I on like Twitter, and I just like thinking about
you smashed that like button.
I thought that was Mama JF being lost in the wilderness. Like I got like blood like telepathy, you know what I'm saying? Like because I'm not only retarded, but I'm also French. You know, all of you guys know I'm retarded. You might not know that I come from French blood.
Same difference.
So like same exact thing. So we're able to telekinetically, you know, like fucking interact with each other. And I know where she's at. She's being hunted. She's nude. And that's her choice to be nude, mm-hmm. as it was at the Republican National Convention.
Right.
But it's not her choice to be chased by No White Guilt, who is also nude.
Okay, so she is at the public park.
Yeah, they're still there. They're still there because No White Guilt's not going to kill her because then it's no fun. Then he doesn't have a plaything yeah. anymore. That's the thing. That's what's going on. And she knows this. She knows this, but she's also having fun. So yeah. it's like a dog. It's like a dog playing with the frisbee.
So no update on JF, the Quebecois murderer or whatever, which is really, that's like the most damning thing is like, don't expect an update. The body's gone. That shit don't just happen.
Yeah, what about Vincent the fucking Salah, kids, bro? Like, aren't they asking questions?
Dog, they're
like,
being they're raised like... by JF.
Your mother was a retard? She died in the forest?
The Chad man should be allowed to murder his girlfriend or wife because he is a Chad. And so he should be allowed to do Chad things like kill.
That's what I do. Space.
He didn't necessarily kill her. He just left her to his own devices. That's his story, right?
Mama was a whore.
That is the public story.
Oh, the public
whore. The bad man pumps and dumps in the woods. In the woods.
JF becomes a schizophrenic. You know?
I do get a big vibe that he was whoring out his retarded wife.
Probably. Like,
that is the vibe that I get from that situation.
That's why I don't want to hear his take on Israel. It's like this people would like you do any fucking evil possible thing you can think of.
Yeah.
Like, well, he literally he just says anything to get a rise. That's why when he has to do an interview for media about his missing girlfriend, he shills his book.
Right.
So. The public book. Anybody can buy it at the mall, at the borders. He buns in Nobel.
I would only want to know his take on Israel to know what Epstein thinks of Israel.
That's like, true.
Yeah, because we got a big donation.
All right, let's look, move man, on to let's move on to some fucking thought, some fucking content. We can finish. Yeah. We can talk about Epstein for a while. I don't fucking know. But we got Gonsfeld here. We want to talk about the Gonsfeld effect.
Hell yeah.
So I'm going to let you spurg out because I didn't do any prep on it.
Oh, shit. Okay. I was trying to get ready, but I
don't have
ready.
Any fucking prep. It's fine.
I'm ready. Let's do it. Okay. Introduction. Sorry. God's what?
Ah, okay. So, yeah, I'm the local Gonsfeld autist. The Gonsfeld effect, it is a altered state of consciousness. It's basically a... just a digital DIY sensory deprivation experience. It's called the Gonsfeld effect because back in the 1930s, a German psychologist basically just made his subjects stare into something completely featureless, like a void. And he would note that eventually they would start to hallucinate visually. So, skip forward a couple decades, in the 70s, some parapsychologists kind of dug this shit up, and they're like, whoa, what if we try and use this for ESP, and, telepathy and shit? So, they kind of adapted it, and they're like, well, let's not just do deprivation of the visual senses, let's throw auditory deprivation in there as well. So they would give subjects headphones, and they play white noise over it. The reason why they'd use white noise is white noise, if you're not familiar with how the audio spectrum works, it's all frequencies that can be heard and measured all playing at the same intensity evenly. So it might not sound like it, but it is technically an even sound. That's why I can block out all other sounds. So anyways, they would basically cover up a subject's face, or their eyes, rather.
The ping pong balls, right? The cut ping
pong balls? Yeah, and I'll get into it, but the ping pong ball thing is fucking ass, man. It's bullshit. Shit doesn't work well. But anyways, like you can dig up like old videos from like the 70s. They'll put on like blindfolds. Some of them, they will do the ping pong balls. They cut them in half and just tape them to your eyes. The idea is just something that looks even. Obviously, with like a sleep mask or whatever, it's all black. If you were to do the ping pong balls, they shine a light in your face. And what that does is if you start to defocus your eyes, kind of like if you're just spacing out, it makes your vision just kind of turn into a featureless, depthless void. And what they found is, the actual findings for ESP and stuff was inconclusive. Some say that it helps
it always
with
is.
Like remote viewing.
Honestly, all of these things, they get studied very in depth. They spend a lot of money on it, and then they say mixed results, and then they make like they toss it away. But really, I think a lot of this stuff goes black.
Yeah, there was a funded Cambridge study on it, and they just basically, if I remember right, it was inconclusive.
Oh, yeah. The whole remote viewing world is like that. I mean, they pretend that they're not getting statistically significant information. I'm too fucking tired to explain this shit.
Do it.
Yeah, no, they pretend that they got nothing out of it. And then like, oh, lives. Yeah, we spent 20 years doing it and nothing happened. Oh, I guess that was just a waste of time and money, guys. Better not look in it. Don't look over here. And yeah, no, they're doing it all the fucking time.
Yeah. So basically, it kind of faded into obscurity after that fad. Only to be like fairly recently picked up online. It's still rather obscure. I think the only times I've ever seen it outside of like maybe like random pictures on like meme sites or maybe like a 4chan thread is sometimes I've seen like the shitty reality TV ghost hunting shows. We'll put people into like a Gonsfeld experience there, and they'll claim that the sensory deprivation will turn the body into a vessel for spirits or entities to communicate with, which, I mean, I do believe to some degree. I would feel rather any sort of sensory deprivation would do that. But anyways, I just happened to come across it one day in one of those just random, like, shitty, hyper-compressed, shared-around meme images. I was like, the Gonsfeld effect. And I was like, well, you know, sure, let's try it. Let's just see what happens. Worst case, I just look like an idiot and I sit here and listen to white noise for an hour. But I found that it worked pretty much immediately for me, for both visual and auditory hallucinations. And I just kind of kept at it for a while, kind of off and on over the years, and made some discoveries with it. Had a few kind of spooky paranormal, what I would assume to be paranormal experiences. I mean, up to interpretation, but it was enough for me to no longer be comfortable fucking with it. But about the ping pong balls. The ping pong balls are fucking retarded because you put them on and you know, you can't cover your whole eyes with the half ping pong balls. There's little slits on the side, so you can just see right out of your peripheral vision. It doesn't really work. It breaks the immersion. So what I would do is I'd actually take a piece of printer paper and I would just fucking tape it all over my face. It sounds stupid. It looks goofy as hell, but it's like everyone has like a sheet of paper around and you just need something white that covers your whole vision, and then you just stare into a lamp. If you don't have a lamp to stare at, you can just put up a white picture on your computer monitor, turn the brightness up, stare at that. But that's the Gonsfeld effect in a nutshell. It was just initially just a side effect that was discovered kind of in the earlier days of psychology, and it got picked up again by parapsychologists, and then it just kind of slowly got passed around between paranormal investigator circles, and now it still remains fairly obscure, but it's just an easy way to DIY some cool sensory deprivation.
Kay, what do you think about this?
I don't.
Yes, you do, you liar, dude. what do you think? So, puts you in like a trance state, essentially. The sensory deprivation, and then we're talking about the possibility of becoming like a conduit for other entities and stuff like that. Like, there's precedence for this in other practices and stuff, right?
Yeah,
right. Sure. I mean, you got your sensory deprivation. We all know you go in the sensory deprivation thing, you're gonna trip the fuck out, right?
Right.
That's assumed. I haven't tried it. Who's tried it?
I haven't either, but it sounds like a great time.
Yeah.
It's similar to some of our practices.
The Sufis.
Yeah, there's like certain orders in Egypt where if you go into seclusion, you're not only put into an underground chamber below the main mosque, but you're required to wear this white veil that covers your eyes and your ears. And you're only let out to pray occasionally, but you're in this like really tight cave, like, chamber that's carved into the rock, basically.
Right, and there's stories of, you know, ancient mystics and stuff and shamans and stuff that would go into it deep into caves for the sensory deprivation to receive visions.
Are we of the opinion that like the pyramids, say the Great Pyramid, is kind of for this purposes, like the acoustics in it might be perfect for absorbing sound or something like that?
Right.
Personally, I think it was some kind of teleporter that was charged via meditation like that.
It's goofy. That
is a cool theory of it actually being like a very simple functional thing, though.
Right.
Versus like all of the various like all kinds of pseudoscience we can get into of like what the pyramids were. They were like fucking UFOs, like in
I think studies have been done on the acoustics in there, and it's supposed to have some very, I don't know, strange acoustics, very particular acoustics.
That makes a lot more sense than like most theories that we'd see on ancient aliens and shit.
Right.
Of what the pyramids are supposed to be. I think they were tombs of something. Like, I mean,
yeah,
like that.
I mean,
was,
sure.
Not even, like,
yeah. We knew very top. Yeah. Absolutely. absolutely.
That makes sense too. That's interesting. That's an interesting way of kind of grounding it in reality as opposed to turning it into this whole, like, you know.
I think there's parallels between the sensory deprivation and, say, like, psychedelic drugs and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
When the senses are totally deprived, the brain seems to make its own stimuli. And when you take psychedelics, suddenly you're seeing all the stimuli that's probably there the whole time. Your brain kind of can't focus on it. It doesn't need to focus on it. It shouldn't focus on it. You'd be distracted all the fucking time, like you are when you're tripping. So it is this stimuli that is, like, innate to you, that's, like, always there, but you have to unlock it somehow.
Yeah, for sure.
Then we're talking about the sound. Another thing is the same sensation with, like, white noise and droning sounds and stuff, like, when you are on, like, LSD or mushrooms or something like that. But then when you're about to break through on DMT, everyone has the story of, like, a buzzing that begins, and it overtakes you, and you shoot out of your own body, essentially.
It's weird. Even with, like, because Ganzfeld state is considered an altered state of consciousness, even with other altered states of consciousness, like sleep paralysis or near-death experiences, you also hear a lot about that, some sort of tone or frequency or buzzing that you might hear and experience prior to breaking through.
Same reason mantras are used and all of that.
Absolutely. When I had my, like, small remote viewing experience where I was, like, asleep in bed, but somehow opened my door and went in and was watching my parents get ready for work.
That's astral projection. You projected. You went to the further.
Real-time projection is some shit.
Whatever it was, it's fucking scary because, like, I all of a sudden realized, like, hey, I'm like asleep. And then all of a sudden I'm, like, in my bed again.
I've never had an experience like that. I've had many strange dreams that were very, very real. And, like, I've been convinced, it's got to be a real thing. It's so goddamn real, so detailed.
Yeah,
but I've never looked at myself sleeping.
I didn't look at myself sleeping. I never did that, but I did open the door, and I don't know if the door physically opened or didn't. I need to, like, ask my parents, because I don't know if they would fucking remember. But
are you implying ghosts, or what's going on here, big guy?
I don't know. Like, I didn't, like, the way it worked was I was, like, asleep, and I was dead asleep, like just asleep, like, no dream, nothing. And all of a sudden, I'm, like, up out of bed, and, like, the door's open, and I'm, like, watching my parents in the kitchen, like, making breakfast and getting ready for work. And then, like, this went on for, like, 2 minutes, I want to say, and they were just, like, talking about cooking eggs.
If it was me, I would have, like, flown around the world and, like, done all sorts.
I didn't know, like, I was kind of, like, in this weird sedated state. That's how I'd describe it, because I didn't know.
I'd go, like, beat up Obama in his astral form.
Or just jerk off on the president's face, give Obama's face.
Astral gooning?
Yes, my ectoplasm.
And then, like, I realized, hey, I'm supposed to be in bed. I'm, like, not here.
Hey, right, it's, like, past my bedtime. Like, that boy ain't right, I'm telling you, dude.
Dead serious. And then, like that's the, I don't know what that was, but that's the only experience like that I've had.
Yeah, I've never had anything like that. I know I have, because, like, when I would do Ganzfeld sessions, like, the easiest...
Goonfield sessions.
Yeah, Goonsfeld sessions. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Ganzfeld Goonie.
Goonsfeld, that is sitcom.
Yeah. The easiest way to, like, get that sort of featureless, depthless void, which is, like, the first step before you start doing the visual hallucination, is, like... Like I said, like, I tell people when I coach, like, friends on how to do it, like, imagine, like, you're spacing out in class, like, where your eyes are open, you're looking at something, but you're not really looking at anything. You just, your eyes aren't really focused. I know I've done that before, lying in bed, just looking at the, you know, the dark room at the foot of my bed, and I've had visual hallucinations happen that way before.
When I've taken like lots of acid, I'd kind of cross my eyes, and it would create like a buzzing in my forehead that would like create this sound that I would just get lost in.
Wacky.
Yeah,
I remember.
That reminds me of like that noise like middle-aged people hear in like Santa Fe, New Mexico, that no one else can hear.
The boomer noise.
Yeah, like the basically. I forget the actual name of it, but there's a tone, and like they've proven it scientifically.
I love Israel. I love Israel.
That's all it is.
Yeah, with those tones and stuff, though, you could even like branch off into like you know, other pseudosciences with like cymatics and stuff, and like Dr. Masaru Emoto and all that shit, and how frequencies and tones can
affect. Was that the water droplets, was it?
Yeah, he's the guy that would play the music and around water droplets and then freeze them and document their crystalline structures.
That actually gets completely into the thing I wanted to get into if we've got time to do that. But
I don't think we gotta finish this thing a little Halloween bit. Or, what do we do? Okay. I don't know. Do whatever you feel.
I mean, I'm good with just tangent spur to spur.
Let's do it.
Naturally. I don't know. Huh?
Go for it.
Okay. Well, the whole water thing is basically saying that our perception is creating reality. That, like, I don't really know how it fucking works, but the water molecule.
They would put something on like the container that had the water, and they would write on it like love or hate.
Yeah, he did all sorts of shit. So he would do the love or hate experiments where he would put, I believe it was rice. He would do cooked rice. And he'd put it in two jars. One would have the word love written on it. One would have the word hate. And you would scream and be angry and say horrible, hateful things to the jar that said hate. And you would...
Fuck you, jaw, whore.
Yeah, you fucking jaw. But then you would be very positive and affirming and say very nice things towards the love jar. And what they would find is the rice in the love jar would be fine for weeks, even though it's been cooked and sealed in a jar at room temp. And then the rice that would be hated on would grow moldy and rot and stuff. But he also did stuff with water specifically, where he would expose a sample of water to various kinds of music, be it classical or heavy metal, like death metal. And then he would take a droplet of that water and then put it on a microscope slide and freeze it. And then the crystalline structures that the ice would form would be different depending on what kind of sounds or music he exposed it to.
Right. So this is kind of, well, okay, so the text I have is it's the CCRU writings of 1997 to 2003. And I don't even remember what CCRU stands for. It's something cybernetic research unit, basically. But it's like this mixture of like chaos magic, Crowley, cybernetics, early internet stuff, and cyberpunk fiction and postmodern theory. But it's like a whole mixture of all these things. But we're talking about William Burroughs in this text called Lemurian Time War. And so that the part that specifically ties into that, let me just read this quote. In the hyperstitional model, Kay outlined, fiction is not opposed to the real. Rather, reality is understood to be composed of fictions, consistent semiotic terrains that condition perceptual, affective, and behavioral responses.
Kay is sleepy boy, and were we making you tired? Are you sleepy, Kay?
Is it too many big words for Kay, I guess? But,
no,
I find that stuff boring.
Why do you find it boring?
It's like nominalism.
And what does that mean?
What are you talking about?
Things exist in name only.
They exist in name only?
I think they exist in every way except their name.
Yeah, so nominalism is the idea that things have no inherent existence and exist only in name.
Well, I think it's connected to the whole water molecule thing in this idea of like, you're writing something and it's basically real in a sense. And the water molecule, you're talking about it on a kind of.
But
like,
you got to get pissed off at it.
Quantum level. Huh?
You got to get pissed off at the water.
What you're telling me is if I want a physical thing to last longer,
you get pissed off.
All
at
I got to do is just be nice to it.
If you want a Russian girlfriend, all you gotta do, Polak, is say I love you right out the gate, and she'll stay with you forever.
In reality,
and there's no negative side effects.
If you're a positive, pleasant human being, things are usually kind of good.
Yeah.
Right. It's a rule. It's not a rule I abide by all the time, but it's a rule.
The part I was mostly interested in trying to bring up with y'all was this idea of the one God universe. And
the three god universe.
That would be preferable to the one god universe. But basically, that like, there's like one single paradigm that like sign. You could, I mean, so one single pair. There's one like grand narrative that everything is basically structured around, and like we're when you watch the news or anything like that, you're basically stuck in that.
Yeah, the unity of being, my even enemy.
University of being, yucky.
What? Yeah.
The unity of being.
Well, I'm talking about
Wajud
like,
al-Wahad or something like that. Right?
Yeah, Wajud al-Wahad.
Like, normal, like when you go outside, the normal reality that we're all exposed to.
See, I like to call it the cum jar.
The world is my cum jar. Da 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 da.
John Dunn's got us versus Aquinas.
What about Aquinas?
I don't know.
Fuck.
I'm talking about how so that whole like experiment with the water and the molecules and us perceiving reality differently. If we can sort of see it as we can like mentally affect reality with enough power, enough like mental focus. But then what is, why aren't we affecting it constantly? Why aren't we changing it? Why are we stuck in this?
I mean, to me, it's pretty clear that we absolutely are affecting it constantly. Just
we are
mostly
affecting
for
it constantly,
the negative.
But I think we're being sort of structured. We're being influenced by people that have more power than us to affect it in a way that's going to keep it the way that it is. Basically.
Yeah, but we are the guards of our own prison.
Right. Yeah, I agree with that. But like, what? Why are we still the guards of our own prison? Like, why are we staying?
Because it is a reflection of us. As much as we can blame the people above us who are setting the agenda, and we can, fine. On some level, we absolutely can. But another level, if we all just stopped doing that shit, it'd be over. But like, it's not that it's that easy. I'm not arguing that it's that easy. But I'm saying like, we really are the one. We are it. We are that system.
Well, what? But
and if it were good, we could be that too.
But I think that even like our desire to get out of it is like
what desire to get out of it? One in 100 fucking people.
Well, I think everyone has like some degree of like a desire for rebellion or something. Almost everybody does. I mean, but it's just like it's thrown in all these different directions. But yeah, what the thing that they're getting at that the concept of the one god reality, your one god universe gets at, I think, is all right. Fuck you, Kay. Whatever.
I don't think someone else is making a noise. Maybe Kay.
I think someone was in their fucking mic or what?
No, it sounded like someone was like fucking using a bong. That's what it sounded like.
Just go.
Okay.
Go.
Okay. So basically, I think that like it's it is us. It is us that are keeping us in our cage, but us. Even us keeping us in our cage is like on a basic level, our identity is this one god universe. Like we have no reason to try to change beyond like, you know, like we'd have to change the way we're imagining things to change what we want to then change reality.
It is a cycle. Some people would look at that, what you're saying, and I think call that like enlightenment, but I don't think that is enlightenment to be like, we have to change this. Enlightenment is like this society, this world, this prison, this nature itself, the universe, it is all a reflection of me, and it is all cyclical, just like my life is cyclical in so many ways. So when you can understand that, like, you are, like, an essential part of that and live like that, you know, not expecting to change, well, that's when change would actually come.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could see that. But you think it's all you?
I mean, that's the only thing you have control over in this entire universe.
You're streaming and you're getting us to, you know, follow your influence, and then other people are watching, and so you do have some influence on other people.
Well, I'm not saying but even that is only what I can influence in myself. That's what it's all built on. It's not built on anything else. I can't do anything to actually make them do it. This is what the DMT goddess told me when I smoked DMT, dog. She was like, go out there and create that so that other people might be inspired by it and create themselves.
Y'all those little clear blue dudes just told me I didn't belong there. They didn't give me any advice. They told me that I wasn't supposed to be there. But I was only 15, so.
What were you going to say about the Diamond Sutra, guy?
Have y'all read that one?
No, I haven't.
Go on.
Give it a try.
Go on.
It's a old book.
Read
it. What's your point?
Read it.
Read it from it right now.
Pull it up right now. Read it.
On no, it's too long.
But then you have to summarize it then. God damn it.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, we got to have some context.
Don't be a bitch.
All right. Let me get the PDF then.
While you're doing that,
give us the McDonald's version.
Let me go off on this a little bit. So Burrow's name's the Dominant Control Program One God Universe, or OGU. He wages war against the fiction of OGU, which builds its monopolistic dominion upon the magical power of the word, upon programming and illusion. OGU establishes a fiction which operates at the most fatal level of reality, where questions of biological destiny and immortality are decided. Religions are weapons. And so, like, so I do agree that it is, like, we have power over this, but we are also shaped by the code that's formed by religion, formed by science, formed by, like, the general paradigm of what we're supposed to
do. Is it saying that words are dogma?
Yes, totally. But also Burroughs said language itself is a virus. He said that language itself is something we have to overcome in order to get past this, like, control mechanism.
And this goes back to the Lemurian talk?
I don't even want to go off on the, so it talks about Lemuria, but it also talks about lemurs.
Well, because, okay, and, well, like, that's not too far up.
I don't even want to go down there. That's theosophy, brother. Oh,
where the fuck's
but it's so not, in this it? This is not theosophy. Burroughs is kind of talking, this is talking about Burroughs, who's kind of talking about theosophy.
Supposedly, in the days of Lemuria, there was no language and people communicated telepathically.
Right.
I don't know if that has any impact on any of this.
So on that level, this is kind of theosophical. Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, they also had a giant tyrannical empire who turned super evil, and then the aboriginals say that it was destroyed by the gods for being this super fucked up place.
So that whole thing that you read, it seems very nihilistic and atheistic.
I don't think this is atheist. I think this is pagan.
It's Gnostic.
Pagan Gnostic.
So is it just anti-Christian then?
I don't think it's really about religion.
It's absolutely critiquing Christianity, right?
I think it's mostly talking about science. I think it's mostly talking about the general paradigm given to us by science.
Dogma in general?
That's what I thought.
The religious belief in, like, reality as it is currently structured and our inability to change it.
Sure.
So this is just a repeat of Nietzsche.
Oh, there's definitely some Nietzsche in there.
These beatnik motherfuckers were awfully verbose for people who, and look, you gotta understand the time period too, because these people couldn't go and, like, read the Bhagavad Gita easily or whatever the fuck,
right?
So
I understand that too.
William Burroughs, this is a writing about William Burroughs,
okay. Right,
be clear, right. But, like, this is written in 1990, like, one. And Burroughs was writing in, like, between 50. He wrote into the 90s, but he was writing from, like, the 50s on, mostly.
Right.
Naked Lunch is written, like, 55, I think, 53 or something. No, I'm thinking earlier. Yeah, I think it was written, like, 59 or something. But it was written before, like, the 60s.
right.
But yeah, I mean, I'm not really trying to say we should, like, really listen to Burroughs and his, like, heroin-addled, you know,
ideas. Yeah, that is it. It's like drug talk from the beatniks into the hippies and all that shit, which is fine. Yeah. It's awesome. I love reading
it. Yeah. But yeah, the part I'm interested in more is, like, dogmatic thinking in general and, sure. and the idea of, like, thinking the multiple, thinking, like, alternative paradigms and the way that our kind of day-to-day life is shaped by this general, like, acceptance of the real, of reality as it is, and, like, and of the fact that we can't really do anything about it.
I generally agree. I wouldn't be so critical of dogma itself. I think it's clear that dogma has been turned against you, but it's basically propaganda. But the thing is that if you can take these dogmatic ideas and apply them in a much more personal, private way, you can get a lot out of it. You can get a lot of discipline, a lot to get out of it. But if you try to apply this, if you have no spirit, if you have nothing inside that you've worked on, you try to apply that dogma to an entire society, it'll just fall on its face because it's not meant to help anybody. It's literally just propaganda at that point.
Yeah, I think taking on a new belief is something that you can totally change your paradigm. And I think this is talking about that, how if you know, the multiplicity of beliefs and the ability to, like, sort of pick and choose and pick one that's useful and also freeing for you in that moment. And for instance, like, if you're an atheist and you know, you think that your life is just nothing and everything's meaningless, becoming a Christian could be something that totally frees you from this kind of nihilism, basically. So that even that would be an escape from the one God reality of science, of like the scientific paradigm. So I guess like what I don't know what they're using this for necessarily. And we can get into that. We can get into Nick Land, who's like involved with these people, or Mark Fisher, who's also involved with these people. But what I'm taking away from it is like, the scientific paradigm that's saying, like, you have to get fucking vaccinated and, you know, whatever we're saying is the absolute truth and everything else is bigotry or whatever.
A lot of these people at the time, like Philip K. Dick, there's a story about him. They have these, like, mystic revelations where suddenly it's like they can see the Antichrist. And that's kind of the vibe I'm getting here. It's like, it's talking about, like, a system.
This almost exactly doesn't mention Philip K. Dick once in this whole text, but it almost exactly parallels what he talks about with the Black Iron Prison and Valis and all this stuff in his work. And I think that Burroughs and Dick are like these weird kind of parallel anti each other figures. But yeah, no, definitely Dick vibes.
Yeah. So, I mean, a lot of this seems to be strongly influenced by German idealism. But to set that aside for a moment, I did get out the book that I suggested and I checked it.
Yes, we're good.
So in chapter 3, it says, all living beings, whether born from eggs, from the womb, from moisture, or spontaneously, whether they have form or do not have form, whether they are aware or unaware, whether they are not aware or not unaware, all living beings will eventually be led by me to the final nirvana, the final ending of the cycle of birth and death. And when this unfathomable, infinite number of living beings have all been liberated, in truth, not even a single being has actually been liberated. Why, Subhuti? Because if a person still clings to the arbitrary illusions of form or phenomena, such as an ego, a personality, a self, a separate person, or a universal self existing eternally, then that person is not an authentic disciple.
That's all then?
That's
chapter three.
That's very interesting. That is very close to kind of what I was
saying. That
was
way more
at.
Boring than anything I read, but also I agree.
I like this stuff. Where the fuck what was I saying? So when he talks about, like, will be led by me, so he's talking about, like, the Buddha mind, right? The Buddha consciousness. What would you call that? Because it's not referring to, like, one Buddha at that point, right? It's talking about, like, the universal Buddha or something.
Well, this one is supposed to have been spoken by the historical Buddha, the Prince Siddhartha.
But even then, like, the idea was that you were the Buddha too, if you could only know that, right? Like, if you could only realize.
That's one of the implicit messages, yeah.
Yeah, there's a similar passage. I mean, I know you hate Crowley and everything, but there's a similar passage in Crowley where he basically says, like, the sorcerer who
everybody just realizes he's gay.
Huh?
Nobody hates Crowley. Everybody just knows he's gay.
He's gay. Yeah. But, like, he's the sorcerer who gained absolute power.
He was a criminal.
Settle down, boys. Settle down.
He says the sorcerer who gains absolute power but still believes he is himself is basically, like, lost, or is basically, yeah. Has learned nothing. Even though he's gained absolute power, he's learned nothing. Whereas the Ipsissimus knows nothing, but loses himself, and therefore he's enlightened. Like,
this is why all these great mystics, including people in Christianity, Catholicism, and Islam, when they reach some attainment, they proclaim that I am God. And people take it the wrong way. They think they're saying that I individually am God, but that's never it. It's saying that there is only God. There is no you and me. There is no anything but God. And, like, that's supposed to be the true realization. That's what they say in Hinduism too. There's a lot of parlor tricks. You can make yourself levitate. You can manifest gold with your hands, but, like, really, it all amounts to very much nothing.
I've told people their memories before when I was real fucked up.
So basically,
off,
we're
like,
all
in
like
a fugue
memories
state
in God's
fucking
head.
Yes. What kind of?
I don't want to elaborate on that. That's too tricky, but maybe.
Yes. Probably.
And all that has form is elusive and unreal.
Yes.
Well, that's something. This is also elusive.
We're not meant to comprehend it. Is the thing where we are not supposed to comprehend it, and if you're able to, that is why you are godly, because you're not really supposed to, but you have the capability to, and that's the trick there.
No, nothing.
I haven't done it. I don't. Yeah.
It's the
wildlands out there, brother. You can do whatever you can fucking imagine if you know how to do it, but fucking most people don't know how to do shit. We're all fucking monkeys. We're fucking stupid fucking monkeys.
Stupid fucking monkey.
You fucking whore. Who is? Where's all fucking
stupid
actually, fucking
if we
furry.
Realized we were just monkeys throwing poop at the wall, we would be better off.
Bro, that's why I
throw right now people aren't realizing that they're monkeys.
I throw a fat.
That's one interpretation of like
shit.
The Garden of Eden.
Right. They're not sitting down eating their bananas. People need to sit down and eat their bananas.
Every so often I just throw a big fat shit at the wall just to humble myself. Realize what I am.
You gotta go back. You gotta,
but yes,
you gotta
Senor gets it. It's like when you see that all forms are elusive and unreal, then you will begin to perceive your
right.
Truth.
Everybody's an NPC.
Everybody's fake. Everybody's a figment. You guys are all a figment of my imagination, according to me.
No.
You know what I mean? Like, I get that.
I live inside
your
walls.
You might not be. Like, I'm not saying that you literally are. What I'm
me.
Saying is, to me, you are. You're a part of me. You are something that I thought of. And I am with. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful thing. That's why. Otherwise, I don't talk to the people in the fucking Aluicord fucking Discord or the fish tank Discord.
So like that's what I was trying to say about this not being atheist. What I'm going off on is like, it's not about atheism. It's about unbelief. It's about unbelief as a kind of a negative force that can become a positive force of creating reality. Through unbelief, through like understanding that like by disbelieving this paradigm in which nothing can change, you can actually start to create something.
I'm more on the opposite spectrum. I kind of believe
it. What?
It sounds like the after effect of German idealism where it leads to disillusion, but what's Senor saying?
Jack, you said that you were a polytheist in the sense that you believe in everything, right?
Yeah, polytheist, yeah.
And that's kind of what I believe in, not only pretty much every deity that anybody's ever thought of, I believe in the power of belief over anything. And I do believe that if people are, if enough people are believing in something, there's got to be some merit to it. It's not like some bullshit.
But that belief will never be conscious. It will never, ever, ever be a conscious decision that has like a large impact on the world. Fucking never.
That's true. That's true.
It will never be. And it could be like, you know, in some butterfly effect fashion, but it will never, ever be individuals' conscious decisions.
It might, that might inherently be the, that might be how it works. It might work, have to work unconsciously. It might be that if we became so aware of that, we could hack into it, that it would work.
You are the cycle. That's why nothing needs to change, because it's happening just as it needs to happen.
I don't know about that. I think something's going to change.
No, that's the thing. When I started believing that the kids are on my lawn because my lawn is the best place for them, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, I could, oh man, I wish the fucking lights were out. I wish I had a light outside. The Mexicans who mow the next door neighbor's lawn have been, every single time they come through and mow a fucking line of my lawn for, I don't know why.
It's to be nice.
They just fucking come through. It's a big ass line. One line of my lawn is mowed, and it makes the rest of my lawn look like ass. You
They're
assholes. These, and I thought about it today. I was like, you know, it just means I need to mow my fucking lawn. It's an indicator that I need to mow my lawn. These Mexicans are reminding me of that. And you got to figure out the reason why things are because I do believe we're so minuscule that until you are past the toil of humanity, you know what I'm saying? Like, until you can get past, because we all live day-to-day lives. None of us are fucking, like, fucking ascended beings. You know what I mean? Like, we're just fucking dudes. And
why your mic keep popping?
I don't know, bro. I don't know. It's a fucking piece of shit. I broke my fucking shit. I'm sorry. I'll buy a new mic at some
pop
point.
Filter.
Got no pop in his filter.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I hear you. We're all normal people, and that's yeah. We're all just dudes, and we're not.
Yeah, until we can get past being dudes, then we just gotta fucking figure out, like, it's just let it go, do your thing. And you might be able to ascend one day if you fucking calm the fuck down. Because I'm ready to have a heart attack in any given moment, but, you know,
well,
I'm not
trying
to ascend.
The doing your thing is creating your reality.
Yes,
I'm
yes, that's my
lure,
point. Yeah,
y'all
that's what...
into a new reality now by reading this book here to you.
Please.
Oh, God.
Okay.
All right.
We'll cut you off if it gets too boring.
Okay, fair enough. Well, I'll start halfway through the chapter then. So, Subhuti, any person who awakens faith upon hearing the words or phrases of this sutra will accumulate countless blessings and merit. How do I know this? Because
that's like my trigger word?
I guess so. How do I know this? Because this person must have discarded all arbitrary notions of the existence of a personal self, of other people, or of a universal self. Otherwise, their minds would still grasp after such relative conceptions. Furthermore, these people must have already discarded all arbitrary notions of the non-existence of a personal self, other people, or a universal self. Otherwise, their minds would still be grasping at such notions.
Stop touching at your
Therefore,
mic.
Therefore, anyone who seeks total enlightenment should discard not only all conceptions of their own selfhood, of other selves, or of a universal self, but they should also discard all notions of the non-existence of such concepts. Then, when the Buddha explains these things, such as concepts and ideas,
where the fuck you going
should
with
remember
this?
The unreality of all such concepts and ideas. They should recall that in teaching these truths, the Buddha always uses the concepts and ideas in the way that a raft is used to cross a river. Once the river has been crossed over, the raft is of no more use and should be discarded. These arbitrary concepts and ideas about things need to be explained to us as we seek to attain enlightenment.
All right, now explain to the class.
These arbitrary conceptions can be discarded.
Why you throw away the boat?
We already used it.
Are you?
But don't. What if you need to use it again?
Go back.
You don't want to use it again. You'll drown.
Kind of rhyme with what I'm saying about unbelief, in a sense that the unbelief in itself is actually a liberating thing.
Ultimately, arbitrary conceptions can be discarded. Isn't it even more obvious that we should also give up our conceptions of non-existent things?
Like, are you saying give up? When you say give up our conceptions,
that was assumed.
when you say give up our conceptions of non-existent things, like stop believing in things not existing?
No, it's like, first of all, stop giving up believing in things existing. Then give up believing things don't exist. Then give up believing in things that definitely don't exist.
Right. Yeah, no, that makes sense.
Thanks, Kay. Wonderful. You cleared it up for everyone.
Did I say earlier, everything's possible? It's just like, you just got to be able to achieve it, but like most of
Christmas
us can't.
Christmas miracle.
So if I want to... Wait. So if I want to fucking deny myself fucking stimuli so that I can reach enlightenment, then what would I have to tie around my face? The ping pong balls don't work.
The ping pong balls apparently don't work according to Gansfeld. I read about the ping pong balls when I was 15.
What do I, if someone right now wants to do this, what do they do?
So, no, you, okay, first you climb into a, preferably a handicap stall in your gas station.
I always use the handicap stall.
Or the airline, or the airport. You go to the handicap stall, and you manage to use your superior agility to flip yourself upside down,
right,
and then proceed to dunk yourself in the toilet multiple times.
I just and then you stay there
until the guy in the one Garfield effect takes over.
You get the white noise effect from the
water. Then you flush. Then you flush and white? Snap your neck, and then you're finally there.
I'm just curious.
I had the soundboard muted.
Huh?
No, carry on.
Hey, I'm just curious what you have against German idealism, because that sounds completely negative. It sounds like a completely negative process, and also sounds completely dialectical.
I will answer 4K on this one, and I think it's because these people took a bunch of Eastern ideas and tried to like put them into like Western terms, and then somehow flipped them to be backwards every time.
But
can he actually address them on their own like terms, what they're actually saying, or is it just like fucking fuck Hegel because like I don't like Hegel as an idea?
Okay.
Hegel had some all right.
First of all, let's preface this with I've never read Hegel,
so you don't know shit about it. You're just saying, oh fuck German idealism. It's fucking dumb. I never read it, but fuck it, it's fucking dumb.
Totally.
I too say fuck Hegel, and I don't read at all.
Fuck books.
I can't read. I'm literally reading books for an hour
and bore the shit out of me. Fuck books. But okay, yeah. Preface what you're saying with you never read Hegel, and therefore,
right.
Anyway, from what I understand about German idealism, it's some kind of Protestant reaction to things that were going on at the time, and German idealism has been widely exported out into the world, and in German idealism, everything only exists in reference to the self. So the only thing that exists in the viewpoint of German idealism is the self.
God. Everything's in reference to God.
Yeah. So then, what's that guy's name? He came after
Heidegger. All of their assertions from this era. Their assertions are things that are found in like Eastern texts, except like they can't get across the idea of like
that's exactly
a perspective of non-individuality. Like they can't do it on the language to do it. So it all comes out ass backwards. Well, they'll write 1,000 pages the whole time talking about like, you know, like the oneness or whatever the fuck, and the whole time they'll be doing it by splitting things into categories and fucking naming things and it's fucked up.
I disagree with that. I mean, I think there's something to be gained with the synthesis of the two, but yeah, they do have a lot of stupid takes on Buddhism. But Heidegger's not an idealist. You're saying Heidegger? I think you're referring to Kay. I think you're referring to
all of German philosophy in oneself.
Can't hear what you said, but whatever.
I think you're referring to Schopenhauer, not Heidegger.
I'm pretty sure I'm thinking of Heidegger, but anyway.
I got a question that's kind of unrelated, but kind of related, right?
No, like
everybody but Maud here has done some sort of hallucinogen, correct?
Maud's done Sufism.
Well, that's, that's good enough if you do it right.
If you consider a Gonspell effect a hallucinogen, yeah.
We do now.
Have y'all challenge count?
Go on, senor.
Have y'all ever got that like fucking blood memory while you're tripping, like where you like go back to monkey?
Yeah.
I've been
like fucking see like everything go like slow, like sand and time type shit, you know what I'm saying? Like the fucking
You're definitely describing tripping, I'll tell you that much.
You know what I'm saying? Like the hourglass. You know what I'm talking about? Like the eternal hourglass fucking going by and you see it all and you're like, fuck, man, why am I a part of this? You know? So you ain't ever become monkey like that?
Mechanism, though. It's existential.
What are you trying to say about Heidegger? I'm sorry. I really wanted to hear what Kay had to say about this.
I don't really have much to say about it other than, like,
I can sympathize with a lot of Kay's opinions on this, but at the same time, I can look at almost any genre of mysticism or philosophy and find stuff I like and shit I don't like. Right. Simple.
Oh yeah. So,
but to answer your initial problem, no, this is not. This is like the antithesis of German idealism. This is like all.
Yeah.
This is like French postmodernism that's attacking German idealism.
Yeah.
Picked up by British people in the 90s trying to attack the previous generation. This is like a series of like Oedipal, like people attacking their fathers.
Yeah,
But the big father is German idealism, and these people fucking hate German idealism.
That's right.
But like Heidegger isn't even German idealism. Heidegger is like existentialism in the 20th century, and he's a fucking Nazi and all that shit. But no, this is not German idealism at all. But on to your point, though, about German idealism.
You can stop talking about this shit too. That's an option.
Yep.
It is kind of,
I'll stream for the next 5 hours. I don't care. It's Halloween, but yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
It's not German idealism.
That's not what I said. But anyway.
What did you say? I'm sorry, what did you say again?
You said it sounds like it.
It sounds like a reaction to German idealism.
Do we have any
reaction to German idealism? That is not
boys.
It is a reaction to German idealism.
I don't know which word it was, but one of those words you just said fucking triggered my MK Ultra programming. It was my
shit.
It was the word that makes me do bad things. So what's up? Do you think they like broadcast some trigger word in Maine sometime or something? Because people be flipping out in Maine. People be shooting people. I don't even know what happens. Because the news will fucking drop and it'll be like, wow, that's like a bad shooting.
Not real.
And then you just go on with your life.
Hologram.
Hologram
his
guy.
His name is like fake as fuck. Like Robert Card. Really? You're gonna tell
Robert
me
Card.
Some dude named Robert Card.
It just found him dead like an hour and a half ago. Like while you guys were fucking. Well, like right after you guys started, they found
really?
Him dead.
I like pulled it. I tried to pull it up, but I didn't find it.
You say Heidegger enough time?
Yeah, you said it like 80 times, and now I have become part of the CIA.
Yeah.
So
that guy, right before he went and did his shooting, he got new hearing aids, and then he was saying that he was hearing everybody around him conspiring against him and talking shit on him.
I didn't know it was hearing aids at all. I saw that he was fucking like he admitted himself to a fucking crazy place.
Yeah,
because he was hearing shit.
Yeah,
I did not know that. It was hearing
and he's Army
aids.
Reserve. That's- There's military ties to all of this too, which makes it.
Was, it, was
it's
he going
not,
on
that's
like
weird,
a real
really?
Life?
But
it's modern day MK Ultra.
Maybe like they can't find him because he transformed into a wolf.
They found him.
You notice how like
he's gotten away.
It's like
he
was found dead behind the bowling alley.
Yeah, he was found dead somewhere. I just saw
was it behind the bowling alley that he was shooting at? That's bizarre because they said for so long that they didn't know where he was, but that's like the first place they would look, right? Just missing 411. He got missing 411'd.
You got fucking fairy landed.
I'm telling you, he transformed into a wolf.
That might be true, actually.
Part of my genetic memory.
I'm sure this has been brought up before, but the first time I really heard about it was from Bacon Bits, the same person who told me about Schizophreniac, the man who thought that his mom was gang stalking him, etc. We were gangs. He had CIA dicks in his mouth. I don't really understand.
CIA cocks. We could read it later, Patreon or something.
Now, the first time I heard about someone like telling me that all of the mass shooters are like mind controlled, gang stalked puppets, basically, and that they are beaming words into people's heads. They're making them do these shootings because of the things they're beaming into their skulls and crap like that. V2K, voice to skull, is what they call it. And it seems to me,
power of the word.
It seems to me that it's very real to some extent. To what extent all these people are telling the truth about it, I don't know, but it seems to exist. Let's watch a video about it.
It does exist.
It exists.
I have something to say.
Well, you watch this video first. Stuff. Too bad.
Keep that thing.
Too bad.
So this is some China shit. China CCTV 7. This was aired on.
About People's Liberation Army. The weaponry program.
U.S. Army mind control weapons were used against Iraqi soldiers in Iraq. They say it was reported by the Washington Post. I can't verify that. I think Maud was talking about this. I want to say Maud told me about this.
I was talking about these.
I got to read this. I got to read this shit. So we got shit reported by the Pentagon. U.S. troops were engaging in fierce battles with opponent troops. Additional U.S. troops deployed to the field used a desktop PC-sized device aimed at their enemy. Immediately, the enemy armed troops knelt on the ground and surrendered. Immediately, the enemy... that's the same thing. November 2nd, 2007, in Sidr City, Baghdad. Armed troops who fought U.S. military tenaciously. Collectively abandoned their lifeline, the weapons, and disappeared overnight mysteriously. These incidents, which can only be seen in sci-fi movies, took place on the ground, in combat, involving real human soldiers. It's truly amazing.
Military uniform is wild.
We can probably cut that, honestly, that's fine. What's up?
What side were they on? Like, who are they fighting for?
It was the American military fighting the Iraqis, and the American military used this device. Yeah. And they all knelt down immediately. Maud, what... You got a thing about this?
So my whole thing was they were using mind control
making noises. It's you.
Mind controlled soldiers still you. To kill.
I'm not green. You son of a bitch.
To kill Middle Eastern experts and diplomats that were in the area. So you would have stories of these special forces guys who would be deployed to an area, and then they would black out and find out that they just killed an Arab diplomat and his entire family, and then black out again, and then they're back at base.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, so, I think... Oh, go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah, and there's stuff like this with the soldiers that committed mass murder on Iraqi villages. They would black out.
Stop diddling around, senor.
Grab their... Who's ever messing with their testicles? Please stop.
Senor, and he claims it's not him, and I'm watching the sounds go exactly with his movements.
Put your bones.
It's vibrations from the floor or some shit. I don't fucking know, but
go suck on a mirror. Anyway, and he would, you know, the whole villages would be shot up, over the course of like 3 days, and then the soldiers would go back to their tents and sleep, and they would wake up with no memory of having gun their weapons and shot any of these people, and just an entire village overnight is dead.
So I think there's a combination of things here. It seems to be implied whatever message was beamed into the brains of these Iraqi soldiers that made them like kneel down. It sounds like it's the voice of God is what they're giving to people. But then at the same time, they're talking about disappearances and all of that. What is that called? Is that a neutron bomb? Is that what's the one that destroys all living matter but leaves everything else perfectly?
There were a story I heard from a reliable source within Hollywood said that the Americans were using a laser that would turn the target into a fetus.
Say, you told me about that fetus gun. I forgot about the fetus gun. Holy shit.
The old people, like the old rich people, why don't they just fetus themselves? And
the old rich people would always live. They would never die.
Yeah, they would just fetus
themselves. Soldiers would be held up in a precarious position, and the enemy would be in a two-story building. All they would need was this laser, and they would fire it at the building, and all its occupants would
be fetuses, revert back to fetuses,
and then the troops would just need to go in there and stomp them all.
Oh no!
So the dead babies was real?
Yes.
Babies is real.
Dead babies is real, most definitely. All right, so we got the I guess the Chinese government. I guess if it's on like TV in China, it's the Chinese government, right? We have them accusing the
Americans.
This guy's
in military fucking fatigues, bro. What do you mean?
I don't know what any of this shit means in China. I literally have no
fucking
idea.
Scene from Spiken 3. Everything is Spiken 3.
Should I give my take before I get too fucked up to remember it?
Why?
Yeah. So, like, I feel like this is, like, if you have the right frequency, the right radio frequency, because I believe that human skulls are like antenna. Like, that's a genuine belief that I hold. And when I was a kid growing up, we've got a shitty fucking radio station, like, literally, like, probably, like, maybe half a mile away from me, right, where I am right now. And I grew up a little bit further away, and it's inoperable now. But when I was a kid, it was a Mexican station. When I would try to go to sleep sometimes, I would hear Spanish in my head. And I don't understand Spanish, you know? And, like,
maybe
it's always been kind of...
It was a demon.
Well, like, no, it was Spanish. It was like the Spanish station. It was like the Roomba. You know what I'm saying? Like it was like the fucking radio station. I could hear like the radio station. And
that's
I feel
take.
Like
the bones.
No, my take is that
sure.
Like I don't think they were doing it on purpose from the radio station. I'm saying like they were just happened to be admitting the right fucking frequency that does the same thing the fucking US military is deploying with the goddamn fetus gun or whatever.
Everything is Spiken 3. Everything is Zero Experiments Lane.
Right.
Right. So the bones in your skull are for sure conductive because they make bone conducting headphones you can use.
Yeah, they just hit the fucking temple.
Right? They just sits on the temple, and what it does is the vibrations go through your bone into your inner ear.
Headphones.
And they vibrate the cochlea and send the signals down the auditory nerve to the brain.
I love my cochleans vibrated, brother. Like that sounds
so like kind of same idea, right? If something like that, the audio frequency can just vibrate through the bones in the skull, go into the ear. I can't see why other frequencies couldn't do the same thing.
And like to this day, like sometimes when I'm going to bed, like I can hear different sounds depending on where my head is. Like if I'm closer to the bed or like on the pillow, I can hear different sounds because like whether it's vibrating.
You hear your parents talking at night.
My parents have been dead for both of my parents have each been dead.
Look,
for
the joke is already fucking tasteless. I'm not gonna feel bad about this. All right, so I'm gonna play this other video. We got the Chinese government accusing the U.S. military of doing weird shit and insurgents.
This guy is a Chinese. This guy looks like Kim Jong Un.
Let's fucking go to let's go to the next video.
They all look the same. It's the same cloning facility.
Oh shit!
Shut up.
A harassment technique seemingly inspired by science fiction is reportedly being used to torment Chinese people, specifically those who dare to stand up against government corruption. An unusual type of harassment has reportedly appeared in China, seemingly taken from the pages of a science fiction novel. Some claim the Chinese regime has developed a special kind of technology used to broadcast information directly into a person's mind. Known as electronic harassment, it's allegedly used to silence those who dare to speak out.
Wang Haibang says
dude.
He's been suffering from what he calls electronic harassment for 12 years. He explained that it all started after he filed a corruption report in 2008. It was against then police chief of the Wuning County Public Security Bureau inside Jiangxi Province. Soon after, he described being illegally detained, beaten, intimidated, and framed. Not long after that, he was involved in a car accident, something he says was staged. It left him hospitalized. He explained that since then, a device has been used to send information directly to his mind.
They observe my mind with the device and watch my movements. They also use the audio function to send voices to my mind, disturbing me round the clock.
Following his trip to the hospital, he says he began to suffer from the unique harassment. Wong says he believes the local police are behind the electronic harassment. That's because, according to Wong, they talk to him through it using their dialect and accent.
They don't talk about anything else. They only talk about what I'm doing, disturbing me no matter what I do. No matter what, they'll make noise and talk to me.
Wong told us that sometimes he can hear five or six people talking simultaneously, even up to a dozen. He explained that to him, it seems that they take shifts talking, insulting and denouncing him, in an effort to spark his anger and make him talk back. According to him, the technology makes it so that only he can hear the noise. He describes it as a never-ending battle in his mind.
The local officials are too corrupt. They seek to kill you with this torture. They thought I couldn't last 2 years. They never imagined I would make it this long.
But Wong's long-term fatigue has taken a serious toll on his health. Now he suffers from symptoms like headaches, weakened eyesight, and shortness of breath. Despite the symptoms, Wong says that his mental health is intact. In order to prove he's not insane, he underwent two MRIs and a CT scan, showing that his brain is still functioning normally. Wong began in Beijing in 2015. It's taken him 4 years to get confirmation about the technology from China's Ministry of Public Security.
The reception staff of the Public Security Ministry said that they indeed have this kind of equipment. It's very expensive. It's available in all police departments at the county level and above. The equipment can monitor your thinking and send voices to your mind and talk to you in your head. That's what they said.
Wong says the Chinese Communist Party, or CCP, currently uses the technology to control tens of thousands of people. He says he's also spoken with other victims, who describe suffering the same round-the-clock noise in their minds. Some of them reportedly couldn't bear it and are believed to have committed suicide. But more and more, victims have started to speak out. The CCP hasn't hidden its intention to weaponize mind control. Regime media mouthpiece Xinhua reprinted an article earlier last year speaking highly of the technology's military and wartime value. The article says the purpose of mind control weapons is not the destruction of an enemy's flesh, but of his will. It also says the new technology doesn't require a chip implanted in the human brain. Instead, electromagnetic waves, light, sound waves, smells, among other things, can be used. Reporting by Xu Wanhui, NTD News.
The fuck is up with that, dog? So
I believe him. Yeah, I fucking believe him.
I do too. Yeah,
I've been harassed that way.
Yeah, I've been harassed through smells.
I too have been harassed directly.
Through smells, someone just walked in.
Oh my god! When they said smells, it fucked me up. It fucked me up so bad.
You've got the Chinese government accusing the U.S. government of doing this. You have the U.S. media, which is the U.S. government, accusing the Chinese government.
Why would the CIA do this to me?
I think it's almost more interesting if it's not real.
I think it's like, clear it's that it's real. It's obvious that
we've
everyone's
all
doing
been
it.
Harassed this way.
I don't actually think I have personally.
No,
I think
you've
I'm
never been. You've I don't never, think so. You've at never least. Been visually, but, auditorily, or like any sensory harassment whatsoever. You've never gotten hit with the artificial sun. Like, you know,
I don't think they ever got me with the artificial sun gun.
It's spreading tool of propaganda that states can use against each other to basically make the other side think, you know, make people think that they're, the other side is doing this to people, and isn't it terrible what they're doing, even though it's like invisible.
Well, this is the thing. This goes right back to UFOs. They don't really have a problem telling you what they have. You're going to find out anyway. All they want to be able to do is blame it on somebody else.
Right.
They turned me into a fetus with mariachi music when I was 8 years old. Come on.
Yeah.
They're gonna turn you into a fetus.
You're gonna lie to me about this? Chill.
So yeah, does this validate the gang stalking accusations that people are making?
Well,
the TIs?
Let's play with this idea so. That it's real. How do you guys think this shit works? Like, how do you think they have an agency? They hire
you guys,
people? Like,
go on, I'm gonna get another beer.
Okay, so like legit?
The Oklahoma City bombing was very much the same way. They said, what's his face, said that he had a chip implanted in his ass.
Hell
after
yeah.
having an accident.
That's what you call it.
At the field he worked in. So you have these incidents of people saying that they have a chip or that there's something wrong with their brain. Well, it was directly next to a nerve. It was easier to conceal.
Yeah, look up the nerves.
There was also the clock tower shooter, one of the first shooters, also said he left a note before he actually went and did it at his home that he wanted an autopsy done on his brain. That he wanted his brain dissected and to look for something because he couldn't stop hearing voices. So there's obviously a pattern of this going way back to the 60s.
I genuinely believe, like how I was saying, like the human brain is an antenna, right? Yep. genuinely believe that, like, especially in this day and age with how much data they collect on you, just from you walking down the street, like you could, like, whether you're like, let's say like there's like an old guy who like he doesn't go on the internet, he has a smartphone but he only uses it to fucking go on or like maybe go on Facebook, but definitely like to call his grandkids or whatever. He barely uses it, hates fucking technology. They still have him in the fucking system through just his cameras on his smartphone, the fucking cameras as he walks down the street. Mm-hmm. And I feel like with what they have, so like there was a law passed last year in 2022, like every vehicle manufactured after 2026 is going to have ambient DUI detection. So like it's supposed to fucking, you know, like turn off your car if it detects too much fucking alcohol. These sensors are not like new. You know what I mean? Like this shit's not new. If they're able to put it into law, this shit isn't something like they're able to get all kinds of different signatures.
Yeah, they're well tested.
Well, this is they literally by the time people fucking knew about Snowden, it was already too late.
Yeah,
they've been planning this shit for a long time.
Yes,
I'm just wondering if gang stalkers are real. How much are they going to pay me to follow a motherfucker around?
I think they have to have dirt on you so that they can just like pay you in like crack, maybe
or cum.
Is this a posting Heidegger posting now?
Yes. Somebody like I didn't know you could do that. You can like post.
Okay,
like,
what did that say?
It doesn't matter. Sincerely, does not fucking matter. I think we can all agree on that much, at least.
German ideal.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Oh, it's just a recapitulation of what you said earlier. Fucking.
I'm gonna go drink some piss.
Let's go back to China and see what that guy's doing in his day to day life. I bet he has a very interesting job.
I'll just piss in a cup. Never mind.
This choir.
Yeah, it's dope, really. It slaps, it comes. He got bars, yo.
Yeah.
He's spitting, dog.
Top 10 rappers in the world.
Glorious video. I'm so glad we have TikTok for shit like this, at least. If it's gonna fucking track me and gangstalk me, like, at least I can gangstalk this guy back.
Oh, this dude got some fucking face. I like this dude's face.
He's a real one.
I hate how my fucking, my shit just goes from sepia to color out of nowhere. It's so fucked.
Does everybody love this music?
This fucking setup is
insane, dude. It is Fallout tier.
I love this shit. It is so good to me. You don't understand how much I adore this setup. It's some shit I would do.
Absolutely amazing video. I'm glad I got to share that with everybody.
Cool. He's got the same mic as you, senor.
Hell yeah, brother.
If that's what CCP funding gang stalking is, is it really that bad?
Okay, legit. Is this worse than this?
Is this better?
No, that's worse.
I'm sorry. So, I forget who I'm responding to. The whole thing about you guys saying that perps are like also blackmailed and gang stalked, and
yeah,
they then
sometimes
are blackmailed.
Settle down, senor. You settle down, mister. So they say that that if like you're gang stalked and you give in to the Illuminati or whatever, then you can become a perp. That is something that they claim once in a while.
Then you can.
Do I just like? Do I just talk to my perps and they'll like recruit me?
I think so.
That's what happened to me.
What do I have to do? What do you think I have to do?
Take the box.
Will they pay me?
Well, that's what you're saying. You get paid in drugs and sex, probably.
So I just have to recruit.
Okay, that's cool.
Pyramid scheme. I just recruit new perps, and then I'm like basically I move up the perp hierarchy.
Well, you know, all these people would just be doing the most shady pyramid schemes possible. The only thing standing in the way of that is the federal government. So if you are the federal government, like, yeah, you're running the shadiest fucking pyramid scheme in history, most definitely.
Damn.
Are there perp referral bonuses?
Yeah, there's commission.
Can I get extra drugs and hookers for referring a friend to become a
Do I get maternal leave? Yes or no?
Wait, I got my check. I got my check. What's going on here?
I think the
my check
one of
George
the biggest
Soros.
Problems with conspiracy theories, obviously I believe most of them, so I'm like a fucking schizo and everything, but the biggest problem with a lot of conspiracy theories is that they assume like a complete moral dichotomy between like the victims of the conspiracy and like the grand conspiracy being like evil as shit, and the victims are good and the victims are can do no wrong.
Yeah,
I think most like gang stalked people would probably switch places with their perps if they, you know, have had an option to do that. If they're really being gang stalked,
well, I mean, that's why a guy like Bacon Bits. That's why a guy like. Where is all this fucking random ass noise coming from? Okay,
you motherfucker.
So, I forgot what the fuck I was even saying, motherfuckers. What were we talking about?
Hey, Bacon Bits. You're talking about Bacon Bits. How he wanted to get.
Oh yeah. So that's why you get messages from Bacon Bits in the fucking Discord about he's sucking CIA cocks right now, and he'll do anything to get out of his prison because he thinks I'm the CIA, and like right. I have the keys to let him out and become a perp like me.
Right.
I wish. I can say that.
Well, you can, dude. Just like find the people that are following you, and then just talk to them, and they'll make you a new perp, and then you just start in the bottom of the pyramid and work your way up.
We are a pyramid. That's exactly what we're trying to be, is a pyramid.
How so?
Well, and then Yakov's a perp. I become a perp. We all become a perp, and then collectively gang stop Rainbow Children at the Rainbow.
But I do think the old pyramid is kind of inherent to nature. Whoever has the power is going to like be king of the pyramid, yeah. King Tut, so to say, be the clone of Akhenaten, be Obama,
the gorilla that has the most bananas,
the banana girl.
Yeah,
that's true. That's true.
I forgot that I'm him.
All right. Well,
there are systems that operate across instead of top down, but. You know, for the most part, yeah, I think most.
I'll guarantee you, none of them systems lasted for any fucking significant period of time.
Gay orgies. Counter-signal
me.
Well, I mean, relationships between friends, between couples.
That's
you know,
not what
I
we're
mean,
talking about. Though.
No, there's always a dominant. There's always a dominant friend.
That's true.
To say the only structure is the top-down structure. I mean, there's definitely like, obviously, if you have a pet, that's you're giving that pet orders and shit like that. But if you have a girlfriend or you have a best friend or some shit like that, you can have a kind of mutual structure where you're both kind of sometimes you're on top.
I guess that's true, but we're not talking about like a nation's worth of people.
Yeah, you can't have too many roosters.
Groups can self-organize, but. That doesn't have to be something that they do consciously. Yes.
Definitely, for the most part, hierarchy dominates.
When you have a business, there's a hierarchy.
There's a pecking order.
I think you can have a good hierarchy where things are actually distributed well and everyone has their say, whatever the fuck. I think it could be done, but it's still going to be a hierarchy, the pyramid.
the relations of, I don't know, I don't want to get into all this fucking shit, but like the relations of like economics to a certain degree, like there is like a, there are exchanges where it's not really clear who was on top of the exchange. Like you bought something, someone sold something to you. Did you, like, you bought something abstract? Like
this, these rules fucking only apply to people at the bottom of the goddamn pyramid.
That's right. I mean, I'm just saying, I'm saying, like, you know,
none of this shit matters if you're at the top of the pyramid, dude. You have as many mistresses as you fucking want. You fucking order anything you want with no thinking about the price ever. Just do whatever.
Eat all the babies.
Hierarchy is the primary way that our society.
The big rooster.
I'm just saying that there are ways that our society can. There are things that happen in our society that are not hierarchical.
I think I think the purpose of reality, everything we're going through here is to distribute power where everybody really can be a functional, meaningful member of their society in a big way. But these aren't things that you can just turn on and off like a light switch.
Yeah.
These are the cycles I'm talking about.
Socially engineered.
Well, not even socially engineered. I think it's even more than that. The zeitgeist. I don't know what it is. It's the cycle. I don't think anybody has to be behind it.
I would say that like hierarchies that have collapsed, hierarchical structures that have collapsed, in the wake of those, you get these weird structures where it's not really clear who's on top. Like take like feminism. Take like feminism for it. Like in the wake of like the patriarchy or whatever the fuck. Like that's not really the thing to the degree that it was. Now it's not really clear. Are women like on top? Are women aren't like on top of men,
but this is the cycle. This is, there's a void and then the void gets filled and then there's a void and the void gets filled. So you try to do this specific thing, then you find yourself with a whole new fucking problem based on it, and then there's a reaction against it. That's just the natural cycle of everything.
The new problem is not necessarily hierarchical though.
We're talking beyond hierarchy
within the feminist circles. There's clearly intellectual giants. There's clearly
I'm not talking about like women empowerment in general. Like women getting the same power that men had to a certain degree.
They don't. They are no matter what we give them, they will never, ever, ever have that.
Exactly. So what do they have?
A circle jerk.
They
the ability to work at McDonald's.
But like also the ability to become a CEO, but like that doesn't necessarily mean that they're simultaneously not oppressing men and they're not oppressed by men. So I think that that's like an example of like where
they are oppressed by a male. He's just like a 5,000-year-old vampire.
In an attempt to fill a void, we've created an even bigger void that will be filled by something. Until that's not satisfying, and then that becomes a void.
But the void is not a hierarchy. That's all I'm saying.
It is a hierarchy, but it's upside down. Because
the thing is, like, when we're talking about the cycle itself, like that is funnel. Like a singular thing to me.
Okay.
When you start, because all of this confusion and the reason for the hierarchy is because of the confusion of all thinking we're like these important individuals.
Right.
When in reality, everything is one, where everyone's a reflection of us. We have everything we ever need. And that's not enough to get you by day to day. I fucking get it. Mm-hmm. But that's the confusion that we found ourselves in. And the only way to organize that is through some sort of hierarchy. And it doesn't have to be explicit. It doesn't have to be written in a fucking constitution, a charter. It doesn't have to, but it will still occur.
I am not denying that at all. Well, all I was saying is that at the peripheries of that hierarchy are all kinds of across. You have this top-down structure that centers everything. The whole society is centered around a top-down structure. And then on the peripheries, you have all these relationships between people, between corporations.
Everything is a game of like trying to coexist. And they can't coexist, but what they don't realize is they are one already. And that works on like every level, basically, I think.
Yeah, it's like society basically acts like one big organism. Yeah.
Well,
I agree.
There's macrorasms and like and you know macro.
We got microgasms. We got this. We got that, dude.
Jaws connected to the hip bone.
We've had full shots of Senor's ass. Like at least five times.
Wreck him.
Like I like to say that Texas is a microcosm.
Cut that out and charge for it on the Patreon, brother. Non-existent like, Patreon. You know,
Skinwalker OnlyFans. Like,
we've shown worse things tonight. Skinwalker so.
Yeah, did you guys see my ass blister? Is that
the
visible?
Chafing?
Yes, it was
the one that Greasy asks about every time he comes near me. Greasy figured out like the address of my neighbor when he saw like a particular landmark in my webcam one time. It kind of scared me.
Wow.
He is the grease man. That's why they kept
having him. Aqualung, my friend.
Is so, he also?
They try to grab him, and they just
this dude looked like he's just having the greatest time jamming out, man. Like loving it.
So fucking, we are going to move from gang stalking to the most gang stalked individual on earth. We're gonna do the Chris Chan update real quick. I'm pretty sure Prater's in control of the store and the streams, and it's all boring as hell now. I think the girl is out of the picture. There's new pictures of him around shopping. The girl is not to be seen. I think Prater was behind the newest videos.
He ran her off.
It's lame. It's all very lame. I don't know. Like, we got to wait until he has another breakdown or something to fucking have any interesting content. Because this ain't it, Chief. Whatever he's doing, like, Let's Plays of Sonic, and he's getting, like, super chats and shit. It's working for him. God bless him. Boring as fuck.
Is this the fucking Chris Chan going legit arc? Like, he just, like, turns into, like, fucking... turns into PewDiePie?
Well,
I don't know.
He's being groomed right now by Prater, who is a group of business-minded, college-aged individuals. A bunch of fucking dorks. But... people have said like that they have protected Chris from like other trolls, from Sockness, from other people along those lines. And like I would say only to the extent that it makes them money, because like if it would make money to go full blue spike on Chris and have him break his medallion into pieces and shove the shards up his ass, like if that would make the money, they would fucking do it.
Yeah, weren't you saying that Isabel was also connected to Prater?
The story I heard is that Prater basically handed off Chris to Isabel.
And why do you think they did Mella. That? Why do you think they did that?
Because I don't think they were specifically malicious in doing that, just from like the information I have. I think they're extremely fucking sloppy. They think they're fucking geniuses, they think they're masterminds, but in reality they're just Discord dorks. And they have no idea. They're playing with fire, dude. Hardcore. This dude fucks his mom. They're playing with fire. Dude, that's what I'm saying. Last time someone fucking tried to do this, Noel was the best attempt at doing this. And when Noel attempted to do it, fucking he had sex with his mother. That's what happened. That's how it ended.
Yeah, I was going to say, don't you think it's possible to gaslit Chris into the fucking his mom? No. I couldn't even say it with a straight face because it's like he wanted to do that.
You might coerce an admission out of him, but he was going to do that shit anyway.
Yeah,
I think the CIA is going to find a use for Chris, and it will be entertaining for all of us.
Anytime the CIA finds a use for anybody, it's not entertaining. That's
always
the problem.
A good thing.
The last time the CIA found a use for him, he fucked his mom.
How do you bungle it up that bad, dude? Smooth text. He's out there being a cowboy.
You're kind of right.
They put
to be
a chemical
honest.
In his water that made. Him
wasn't there? Wrong. Wasn't there a bunch of shit going on at the same time that Chris Chan like fucked his mom? Wasn't it a big time for events?
All sorts of dumb crap be happening perpetually.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I have no idea, bro.
Internet people don't care. Make Chris Chan fuck his mom.
Yeah. The Israel thing distracted us from Ukraine, and eventually they're going to want Chris Chan to distract us from Israel.
That's true.
Well,
let's look at better times for Chris Chan. Let's talk about some Chris Chan Halloween. Fuck off, senor. Not doing whatever tangent this is. We're talking about Chris Chan.
I was gonna ask, would you rather your child go to fucking Tel Aviv, Israel, or Rutgersville, Virginia?
Rutgersville.
I'd rather go to Tel Aviv and then.
Anyway. Any fucking way. So we're going to go over the historic Halloweens of Christery. So in 1998 or 1999, Barb makes Chris an Ash Ketchum costume for Halloween.
Oh God.
I have the image of this. I'll pull it up for everybody to see. Here you see.
Hell yeah.
I would love my mom. She made this for me.
It's not a terrible costume. It hits it pretty on the head there. He's got the hat, the Pokemon League hat we see, the classic vest.
How
he's got
old
the,
is Chris at this point?
He's got the gloves. He's probably
35.
He's probably like 13 here. Maybe a little younger. 30. He looks young. Why?
He looks like he's in preteens to me. So yeah, maybe I'd say teens. Like,
maybe I 12 maybe. Maybe. How much younger?
He's a good looking boy.
But okay, so God, now I have to figure out how old he is. I don't remember. He's like 40.
He is like 40 now.
Oh, whatever. So 98, who can say, dude? Time flies so fast when you're having fun. I think he's like 12 or 13 here. So yeah, there's Chris Chan in his Ash Ketchum costume. Let me just go to the next one. Here we have another view of the sweet fucking car of the Ash Ketchum getup. I don't think this is Halloween. Just hanging out like that. He'd be doing that.
I thought, wait a minute. Is that Jim Cornette?
It looks
that's Jim Cornette.
For all the wrestling fans out there, it looks just like Jim Cornette. It looks exactly fucking like him. It's kind of fucking creepy.
It's hilarious.
Yeah,
holy
it's weird.
Shit.
So yeah, then we move on to 2007. Halloween 2007 coincided with the emergence of Chris Chan on the internet. He appeared in a Something Awful thread on the 26th of October, got an Encyclopedia Dramatica page on the 3rd of November, not Halloween itself, as Chris has claimed, and 4chan fan art existed the next day. So it was 2007 when he became a meme. It was Halloween of 2007 when that boy became a reality.
What a monster was born into this universe.
2008. Chris had hoped to go with Blanca, who was just one of his troll sweethearts, to a local Halloween party, but unfortunately, she stole his medallions and outed herself as a troll before he could. He said he had no plans for Halloween, and so a crack squadron of trolls, including a bunch of retards, infiltrated the grounds of 14 Branchland Court that Halloween night, leaving a sign reading Encyclopedia Dramatica, Heart Jimmy Hill, on the front lawn. Chris went apeshit, and a year later, tore up the sign on YouTube, while making death threats against a bunch of trolls. Chris later claimed that Mims and Megan were the ones who left the sign Megan Schroeder. This is unconfirmed and extremely unlikely. Mims never had anything to do with ED, and Megan has never shown any sign of engaging with trolls whatsoever. So, yeah, it was a gang of unruly trolls. Let's go to that video of him messing with that sign, dude. Let's have a look at that sign.
It's on the eye toy, right?
Yeah.
Apparently my heed of warning towards Vivian has gone unheard, or otherwise she did not realize the fury of my wrath.
He's got the piss yellow.
Yeah, the good old piss filter.
Deed. That's right.
So yeah, let's begin with a visual aid. Stop me if you have not seen this before.
It's the Encyclopedia Dramatica, Jimmy Hill, heart there.
Now watch what I do to this, as I will do to Vivian G if she does not take down every last one of her videos and closes her YouTube account.
Yeah.
Look at that boy.
He can't break that.
So he's already at this time. He's already threatening violent women.
Oh, absolutely.
This is for Clyde Cash too. Every last one of his family members, including his guy Vivian.
Oh shit!
He told.
He got stabbed.
Yeah, and he—that's the thing—is that he told Megan that he drew pictures finger banging her so that he didn't act out in real life on that.
That's so not a good thing to tell.
Yeah, he's got no game, as it were.
In Minecraft.
Oh shit, he Ozzy'd it. That's awesome.
He Ozzy'd it.
That's fucking cool.
He's so mad.
There's no way he's not self-aware, bro. That's crazy. That's so... Oh my god. You're not telling me this motherfucker hasn't been fucking playing us for this long. Are you shitting me?
Jesus. He's Jesus Christ, aren't you?
This is a fucking vignette, and he did the Ozzy gimmick.
It's amazing. He's,
what the fuck?
Things just fall into place. He is not self-aware, I promise you.
So,
don't be too
what
afraid
the fuck,
yet.
Bro? This is good.
Oh, fuck. Right,
so we move on to 2013. Halloween 2013 was a true dark night of the soul for Christian. On the 30th, he received the traumatic news that his Manchester High School gal pals were neither true nor honest. I am shocked to hear that everyone was my friend because they felt sorry for me. I'm shocked to hear that everyone's my friend because they felt sorry for me. This realization, only 13 years too late, that his friends were playing Pity the Autistic and didn't really like him, crushed Chris's one really happy memory. He posted to one of his gal pals asking if she too was merely being nice and called his old MHS classmates to visit his house in person to apologize for what is unclear. In keeping with the holiday spirit, he said he felt, as in the previous year, like an emotional zombie.
Emotional zombie?
That's how I feel most times.
Yeah, so he found out that all of the girls that were his friends in high school, they were, first of all, they were just pitying him, and that's why they were hanging out. But also, there's talk that Chris's dad was paying them to, like, watch out for him. Oh, which is weird. God. That's a weird relationship.
That's very fucking weird.
A little
weird.
Complicated.
Grown-ass man goes up to high school girls, hey, I need to pay you money so you can pretend to like my son.
So, 2014. A week before Halloween 2014, Chris asked of his Facebook friends, can anyone recommend any legitimate and good Halloween parties in the Charlottesville, Virginia area, please? He eventually made the very atypical decision to spend the holiday patronizing the Impulse Gay Social Club dressed as a groovy 70s lesbian chick. Chris had originally hoped that if his girlfriend Catherine was in town, they could wear costumes with a lesbians through time theme. And her as the past lesbian, and himself as the aforementioned hippie. Unfortunately, she couldn't come, so Chris had to go alone.
She couldn't come.
Come. Right. Yeah, you could have left it there. Bro.
Right.
Just couldn't.
2018. Chris dressed as Princess Savina in her warrior disguise from the Smurfs cartoon series to attend a costume party at a local bar and grill. He also claimed that his spouses Magichan, Chriselle, Sylvana, and Mewtwo were also dressed as Smurf characters. That's what kind of why I'm doing this. You can see the deterioration of his fucking mind just by, like, me reading what he did on Halloween.
Like, who showed him the Smurf? Like,
dude,
like, how
what
do
you
do
mean, dude? He is raised by, like,
it's on
90s
Boomerang.
TV. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it's on Boomerang, that's right.
2019, Chris celebrated Halloween by warning readers that the dimensional merge is coming close and to stay safe from the OCs. The holiday would mean that the dimensional iron curtain was thin. So we're getting clearly more unhinged here. 2021, Chris spent Halloween in Central Virginia Regional Jail after his arrest for incest with his mother. There we are. We've gone full fucking crazy here. We've reached 2022. Chris spent Halloween in Central Virginia Regional Jail for the second year. So that's how it be. No thoughts? Just puts a button in it.
I mean,
I would just like to... We need to interview the guys who were, like, cellmates with Christian.
I hear you. Yeah. He was in, like, protective custody, essentially.
Yeah, but who was he playing cards with on the prayer rugs?
I think he was playing fucking solitaire, first and foremost. But
you got any, like, any person?
I'm pretty sure he said he was playing solitaire.
Yeah, he did. He in one of his letters, he did say he enjoyed playing solitaire on the rugs.
So there was a little bit of interaction. He talked about, like, an older woman that he was twin flames with or something, but really it's not anybody you'd be able to contact or find any information on. Maybe years down the line.
Figure out who
maybe he was just hallucinating his mother in jail.
I've thought about that. I actually have. I think that is a valid idea. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, because Barb is his, like, that's his soulmate, right?
I don't know. They soul bond. That's all I know is they soul bond.
Soul bond.
They're the same person.
Soul bond.
Yeah.
So, like, when Barbara dies, inevitably.
Yeah, Chris Chan will take on the persona of Barbara Chan.
All right, so
Ted Bundy with his mother.
Guys, I got an idea here. We're gonna do a costume contest featuring all Chris Chan. So here we have Juggalo Chris Chan and his Juggalo getup.
Whoop whoop
whoop whoop, brother. It's not a bad costume, right? I think we've all wanted to go as a Juggalo to Halloween when we were children. Every one of us.
I think the yellow is a bit much.
Well, he's Sonichu. It's because that's why he's got the red fucking cheeks.
Okay, no, okay, he's representing. That's his people. That's his people, and I can respect that.
He's Jirokian.
Yeah, no, that makes sense.
All right, what do we on the scale of costumes here? What do you think this is going to get? I think this is like
it's a five.
I think I would give it the six because there's heart in it. He actually rapped like the whole song in this video. We're trying.
Oh, seven.
Oh, hey, yeah, I'll give him a six. Yeah, he'll get a five.
That's a solid seven.
It would have been a five because he put the effort in, but it looks like shit. But if he's gonna like give shout outs to the Juggalo homies and rap, dude, the Dark Lotus, yeah, dude, gang gang.
It's pretty much a seven.
I'd give him a seven if he showed up to the gathering, but yeah, otherwise I'm gonna give him a six.
I agree. I'm with you there. That's
yep,
perfect.
Six.
Here we have Chris.
Perfect.
My
wait, may I just ask, is this Christine Weston Chandler? Because they're looking a little busty.
No, this is Christine Jamal.
This is Chris Chan in blackface.
Is this
and
I'm genuinely asking. I'm genuinely asking, is this pre or post Christine?
This is pre.
Are you
he's still a man, baby?
The tits.
He's a man with tits. What's your problem?
So like the trolls like snuck a bunch of like neo-Nazi shit into his lore and shit. So you think this is something they actually told him to do?
This is Mr. Popo.
Full disclosure.
This is Dragon Ball Z.
I have asked many a black man if I'm allowed to dress as Mr. Popo for Halloween, and I've been told yes. I've been told yes. So every single time.
The blue version from 4Kids.
No. I'm allowed to be everybody who has watched Dragon Ball Z. Mexicans and black people love Dragon Ball Z. So you say, you know, like you say, okay, can I, as a white man, am I allowed to be Mr. Popo? Hell yeah, brother.
So what do we get? What do we give this? I think I give this an 8 because I think it's the funniest shit in the world, frankly. But
yeah,
if he was willing to go out in public like that, I'd give him a 9 if he was not afraid to get his head bashed in for dressing like that.
Solid 9 for me. I relate to this fit a lot.
the popo.
I'm an 8.5.
It gets an 8 because I don't see the pants.
That's true.
I don't see the shoes.
They got to be the parachute pants and the genie shoes.
Pointy toe shoes, yep.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Mr. Popo's a djinn.
Yeah, he's a djinn.
God,
yeah.
It's even
worse.
That's the whole deal.
That's Mr. Popo's whole deal.
Okay.
So I'm gonna give him a 7 until he goes out in public. At which point, I would give him a 9.
Yeah. All right. That's
if he goes out in public like that, then he's got more balls than I ever would.
It's like a Die Hard 3 moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is a Die Hard 3 moment.
Here.
He's Grimace?
We have Grimace. Your lovable burger distributing monster.
You see, like,
this dude got pickle eyes?
I am seeing pickle eyes, actually. Grimace, I don't know if that's the piss filter or if I'm just hungry.
The Grimace shake carts.
Yeah, dude.
Does he actually do the Grimace shake in this video?
Do the Grimace.
Is this the source of the Grimace shake? Is this where it's from?
Yeah, he murders a
Can we milk the Grimace shake out of him?
So
Grimace shanked Barb's pussy.
I give Grimace Chan, I think, a 4 because I don't really like corporate mascots. Pretty fucking lazy ass costume.
Pretty low effort. You could have put like a purple shirt on.
I'm gonna be a little harsher. 3.
I'm a descent.
I'm gonna give it four.
This dude got a 7 or an 8 to me because I immediately recognized it was Grimace and I saw his effort with pickle eyes and it's an autistic.
It would have been
tip.
Way better if he was just shirtless and we could see his nipples poking out.
To me, it's a retarded man doing his best, brother.
Protruding.
You know, like,
I'm going to abstain. You know?
Yeah.
All right. It's not very high scores. Here we have...
Oh, shit, yeah.
Like basically this. Blackface again, I guess.
Right, face?
No, this is the warrior. Yeah. This is fucking ultimate warrior, brother. What do you mean?
Here, this,
isn't this shirt's awesome. He can do it.
This shirt is
so cool.
This is Clyde Cash. And if you remember the Clyde Cash image, the avatar, it was like a Jersey Shore Goomba, like orange with spiky hair. You know the fucking one. So... And I love the shirt. I would kill for an "I got what I deserve" T-shirt.
That's what
that
I'm
is
saying.
Funny
that is
as fuck.
I've ever seen. Can't you? Can
I will
you
make
sell
this.
That?
I could. T-shirt. I could make
yeah,
the "I got
no
what I deserve"
T-shirt.
There's
a t-shirt. Trademark on that.
It's in the same vein as "I'm the guy who fucked up my life" T-shirt.
No, I would love the "I got what I deserve" T-shirt while I'm walking around some place with my family. That'd be so cool.
Clyde Cash gets a solid 6. I like this. Doesn't go too far with it, just far enough.
Love this shirt. Solid.
I'm gonna
6
give it
again.
I think 6 is it. 6 is good. Yeah,
it's generous. Yeah.
You get 6 from me, brother.
Hell yeah. Here we have.
What is this?
We have Cherokee Indian Chris Chan. He's a Cherokee in this one. He's a Native American.
This gets an 8.
Ooh.
Chief Autism.
Now, keep in mind, I don't know if this will hurt or help the scores, but when Chris Chan got his fucking 23andMe or whatever the fuck, there was no sign of Cherokee DNA anywhere to be found. I don't know if that makes it better or worse.
Okay.
Why does everyone
still
have family?
My books.
I'm going to give him a 6. I mean, and that's because he's showing a lot of skin. Otherwise,
yeah,
because of the skin, I'm going to bump this up to a 7. Would have gotten a 6.
He went through the trouble of making an origami tomahawk.
Is that
a
loincloth?
No.
He's wearing the loincloth over jeans. Holding. That's the issue.
Yeah it's disappointing. He's holding a
that's paper not the Cherokee tomahawk.
Way. That's not the
Cherokee. I'm going to bump this up to 9 because of the
is the loincloth made out of the same construction paper that the grimace was made out of?
Yes,
appears
like it. Yeah. Same shade. Yeah.
Okay. So this is actually an anti-corporate message.
Wearing grimace as a loincloth.
Yeah.
Oh fuck!
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
That's 10. That's 10.
Contrary to popular belief, this is not Chris Chan dressing up as Sonic the Hedgehog. This is him turning into his Sonichu form, his true Sonichu, his perfect form.
His true
yeah,
self.
I thought he was Sonichu immediately. Okay. That's what I immediately...
But he is a Sonichu. He's not Sonichu. The Sonichu, the namesake of the comics, is a different Sonichu than him.
Well, I thought it was like
a Father,
Sonichu. Son, Holy Ghost type deal.
Yeah, well, that's true.
This receives
it,
a 9.
I thought it was
he's
the...
a Sonichu auto.
It would be a 10 if it weren't
Father,
for the blue jeans.
The bear.
Here's the thing. It's a 9, except for the fact that he's not wearing a shirt.
That's what makes it a 9.
That's what makes it a 10 to me.
I think that bumps
it
up to a 10 that he like painted his entire body blue. His fat fucking body. That's ridiculous.
Okay, said blue jeans.
I think this is a 10, unless another costume is better than this. I can't imagine that.
This is definitely a 10. And if you look close at his hands... One of them's got a blue light. The other one's got a red light.
It's true.
Knowledge of good and evil.
I don't think he's holding anything. I think those are spirits.
Definitely channeling something.
They are.
He's got
the
ears, too. One's pointing down. The other one's pointing
up. Like Eliphas Levi's Baphomet.
Right.
It does appear to be in an altered state of consciousness induced by the Goonfield effect.
By the chaos crystals.
The Goonfield effect. Oh, yeah.
The cannabis crystal. All
right, so this is a high tier one. I think this is the favorite so far, frankly.
Yeah, it's 10, brother.
For sure.
It's an all-around 10. 10.
Here we have, now, you might, it might not be immediately obvious what he is here, but he's Cleveland from the Cleveland Show, being in blackface again, to be honest.
No, but it's not, because he hasn't painted his face black.
It's low effort.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's really low effort.
Like a 7 at best.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it a 4.
I'm gonna say, yeah.
I'm gonna go 1 here. I'm gonna go 1.
4. Right. Go 3.
Yeah.
The sweater doesn't even match Cleveland's sweater.
I give it a 2 because I get a chuckle out of it. For no other reason.
It is kind of funny, but that's the only reason non-rated.
Yeah, this one's whack. So I think we have a winner, and it is Sonichu form Chris Chan in his ultimate form.
I mean, there's so many esoteric messages going
That's
on.
True. The mind control just doesn't stop.
Look above his ears. Look above his ears, the fucking things walking around.
The Sonichus?
There's like a happy face to the left of that. There's some fucked up shit going on. Like a horror film.
Dude, I literally think his pants are painted on too. It looks like
it does look like that. It does actually. You're right. And like he painted on a belt at his fat line is really what it looks like.
AI generated pants now.
Holy fuck.
Like I can see
it
like
a real photo.
I can see it like fat coming up the cock.
You can't see a cock. That's how you know it's not fucking painted on.
I can't see the bend in his cock.
Yeah, you can't even see the bend. Man, that's wild.
It's Halloween. It is Halloween night right now. It's Halloween night, and nobody said cloaca. So I'm gonna get.
Is it Halloween right now?
Right now.
It is Halloween. It's not. Yep. Here we go. We got a drink.
I did hear cloaca.
It's Halloween, brother. I told you.
So you go. If you go to Gatorland in Orlando, Florida, you can go see the skunk ape. They got a Mexican dude. They pay fucking minimum wage to dress up as the ape, and he'll fucking do some shit for you, and he'll wrestle an alligator.
What happens if the actual skunk ape like finds him and then tries to molest him because he thinks it's like a female skunk ape?
Yeah,
Florida
skunk ape cock.
Well, get your
Florida's
camera.
Cool, bro. So like skunk ape, he doesn't come to the tourist trap. He doesn't want a photo taken. You know what I mean? You gotta remember, he is a cousin of Bigfoot.
Is there a skank ape?
Yeah, brother. Like, boy. Yeah, brother.
Skank ape?
Yeah.
I'm there, dude.
Yeah, brother. You want me to make some phone calls, bro?
The Patterson footage, you right? She has some pretty big Bigfoot melons, right?
Yeah,
you want to come to the ocean center?
They have to like throw their melons over their shoulders to run.
That's true. That's how you escape. You make it so they can't. They can't juggle their tits.
They use a milk screen to run away. It's like an octopus.
Y'all ever see emus fucking peck each other to fucking death? Bit pretty much.
Yeah, like my neighbor has emus, and they're kind of like.
I see that shit all the time.
God damn it.
Yep.
Don't mention birds of any kind. Oh, no aviary.
They're like really big chickens, right?
Yeah, one of their eggs equals 24 chickens.
No, they're not. They're like fucking. They're like I mean, I guess they're closer to really big chickens than they are like fucking.
They're basically dinosaurs.
They're basically dinosaurs. Yes. Damn. They're basically dinosaurs. Feet, yes.
They're bulletproof.
Feet are dinosaur feet, but their bodies are big old burps.
I imagine that percussive sound that they make is what dinosaurs would fucking sound like.
No, I saw them motherfuckers peck each other like nothing. Like it was like they would cut into each other's flesh to the most deep extent over like the littlest bits of that tourists were like British people were trying to feed them. There were many Brits. The Brits love gators. That's what I came out of bringing my 2-year-old in Gatorland. He was like, dinosaur! And I came out of it. He came out of it like, I got to see dinosaurs. I came out of it like, fucking British people don't understand what a gator is. Like, they're like trying to reach over to the gators. They're like trying to like fucking... They're like trying to reach into the fence portion of the fucking bobcats and the Florida cougars. Or the Florida Panthers. The Florida Panthers
average
are...
British person,
They got urban foxes. They got urban foxes, so they figure, you know, the urban fox is pretty.
There's
friendly.
No urban foxes in Gatorland, brother. Them Florida Panthers are fucked. They got big old fucking flappy stomachs.
See, English people are used to like making friends with dragons and talking to them and shoving them in, like,
that's what
pit.
Living on an island with no predators does to a fucking people.
I went with my wife before she was my wife. It was on like a blood fucking moon or some shit, and we went camping, and it was the coldest night of the fucking year. And it was at the springs. I don't want to dox myself, but in Florida we have a lot of springs, and it was one of the springs. And the fucking next morning, like, no Floridian is at the springs in February. And the next morning we go down to look at actual, like, Springhead, and there's, like, British children. Like, oh, it's very nice in here, mother! And we're like, what the fuck? These kids are, like, what the fuck? It's like fucking, this shit's gotta be, like, fucking freezing temperatures. They're just swimming around. These Brits have no shame.
What the hell are you talking about?
British people disrespecting my state.
Didn't some dude get sucked up into one of the fucking
British streams? People and Florida people start fighting? I just want you to know that I just want both of you to destroy yourselves. It's basically Palestine and Israel all over again.
Yeah. So yes, people do get sucked into the springs. They will go into the springs thinking that they're caves. They're just limestone caves.
Dude,
and
I
really,
I can get a good sucky off of that thing.
Yeah, they're gonna get sucked in the aqua. Here's what happened.
My dog flipped out when he heard that noise.
when you heard you get sucked into the aquifer. That's actually happened. At the spring that I was mentioning, they have, like, you can go into the springhead, like, you can, like, snorkel down there, and they have a cage over it. Do not fucking pass this. And I went to one in the Ocala National Forest, and I saw fish fucking and crabs fucking. And
this is fake news.
I can't. No, that's true. No, it's true. I thought they were coming on me because they came by and they
fish,
like,
don't fuck. They just spray cum everywhere in the lucky.
That's exactly what I'm saying. That's exactly what I'm saying. You didn't see what I just did. They came by.
This another excuse to say cloaca?
Well, yeah, out of their cloaca, they squirted.
Yeah, they do.
You saw fish drive by cum. Yeah.
They
drove by the cum into me, is what I'm saying. In the Ocala National Forest, I went to Silver Springs or some shit. One of them had saltwater crabs that were fucking mating, and the other one had some sort of fish.
You literally saw crabs mount each other and, like, whisper in each other's ears and, like, caress each other.
Yeah, they were fucking getting it, bro. They fucking put on some very white.
It's sexual, baby.
Yeah, Bro, I was so hard.
God.
Bro. No, it was serious, though. With the the fish fucked me up because, like, I saw the fish come. And that's when I was like, I am, like, swimming directly. My face
did
is
you taste it? Who tasted it?
I didn't, kind of fish, but...
You did. If your I face, it was all over your face. But,
was it a red drum? Was it a black
I think it was
drum?
Some sort of bass.
Oh,
does that make it better or worse?
In Japan, they eat fish cum.
Well, you say
the fish
gum, like,
was all over
him. Like,
in Japan, they boil fucking eggs in piss.
It's true.
I don't think it is, actually. Piss? I think I just lied about that. I slandered Japan.
China. Now, there are piss eggs somewhere in Asia. I don't remember
where.
Why wouldn't there be piss eggs? That sounds intuitive to me.
No, they're called virgin boy eggs. That's the best part.
You have to stick them up an 8-year-old. For 10 years. Once he comes,
I'm gonna stick this in your urethra. Oh, no, no.
Egg sounding?
That's what the last scene of Schizophrenic was. He was shoving an egg.
Oh, God.
Damn it, man. Don't bring that scene up again.
I know. That's the craziest thing about the fucking movie is that, like, it's not a good movie, but you're enjoying it because it's so fucking insane. And then it gets to the end and it's like a legitimately, like, fucked up twist that kind of haunts you.
That was.
It's
very,
fucking
very
wild.
Dark.
That's why the movie's so fucking amazing. And, like, it's sloppy. It's, like, it's not like it's that clever. But, like, it achieves what it was going out to achieve. That you're like, oh, what the fuck? Which I think is what you're aiming for.
Yeah. What was the twist?
He was just sitting
the
there.
The dummy was an actual child.
Yeah, and the dummy was an actual
rubberneck, yeah.
He was abusing.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, that's where half the MK Ultra shit comes in. Is that there's, like, human trafficking and, like, satanic ritual abuse vibes happening in it.
Yeah, that was definitely some, like, Hatcher-like
fucked
fucking
up shit.
Exploitation
yeah,
shit.
Ashley Hatcher stuff.
How's she doing? Ashley, do we have any updates? Like, is she doing cool?
Corey Taylor doesn't want me. I bought dog bones.
She's not well.
Did she get new dog bones?
Email me dog bones.
You know you can buy dog bones on the dark web easier than you can buy children.
Dude, this is how crazy Ashley is. I don't know what's going on with her. She looks decent by her standards, as in like her face isn't covered in like wounds with like metal stuck through it and shit. That's not happening. She's ranting and raving like a crazy person. I'll tell you this. She's in some fucking RV and like, okay, so she got taken out of the hell house. All of her mummies, her dog mummies and whatever roadkill she had got taken away from her. And that's a bummer. So with her fucking, whatever RV she's living in or whatever the fuck this thing is, she has filled it with Halloween decorations of dog skeletons. And they're just like plastic Halloween decorations. They're like goofy looking. They're silly and fun looking. But she has like fucking, she has like 15 of these goddamn things lying everywhere. And I know she got them to replace the dog mummy skeletons that were taken from her from the Hell House. Ashley Hatcher. I don't know how to update people. I like, how do I bring you up to speed on this?
Corey Taylor doesn't want me. They're using my face. I don't want you in my body.
I thought now they're looking at, they're using her pussy.
Dude, where do you even...
She keeps talking about a woman raping her.
They're taking my face. I don't want you in my body. You can't have my face.
That's mental illness, baby.
It hurts her vagina.
Really been the theme of the evening for this Halloween.
That's true.
I embrace it. I try to embrace it. There's no other option. I am a pawn in God's plan. I'm part of his plan. And really anything I do is like, you know, just fulfilling my destiny at this point, dude. So I just listen to God whenever he tells me to do things. I simply do them.
Don't come to school tomorrow.
God tells me.
God told me.
Oh, fuck.
Almost shoot her right after it happened. But God told me not to show up. I knew to get your number intuitively, but God told me not to show up. You didn't tell me, you son of a bitch. You scare the mass shooter by telling me. You didn't tell me. God told me. You should have told me, you son of a bitch. Like, oh, fuck.
Ah, beautiful.
You're gonna shit and cum?
We're gonna shit and cum all over the place. Do we have any other topics to bring up? Anything else? Any other tangents we would like to go on? Please go on.
I got something like spooky from like the standpoint of people that would care about this. Basically, the fucking U.S. government not allowing any arms or ammunition exports out of the country.
Yeah, I heard that.
Which hasn't been a thing since like World War II bullshit.
Well, yeah. I honestly do kind of buy into all the hype about, like, the next big war. They're, like, gearing us up for the next big war. Yeah. I do think that's happening. Yeah. I don't know any details, but I think it's happening.
Well, China's in a shooting war with Vietnam right now. So.
I told her, I was like, they're going to start priming us. They're going to start trying to, like, make fucking, like, put into media that, like, the soldier is the good guy. And, like, they're going to start making them seem like the heroes again, like they did back
after 9/11. Yeah, like
And this is
why is China attacking Vietnam?
Is it happening?
It's something about like water or some bullshit.
Water.
There was a Sino-Vietnamese war before, and it was because Vietnam was on the side of Russia.
And Vietnam beat the shit out of them.
Well, they fought for like 3 weeks. They fought for like a month, and China
had a horrible doctrine.
It was just like, this is not a good idea. Unlike America, which stayed there for a fucking decade, but.
I need a brewski. Yeah, keep it going, boys.
That's the thing with like the Sino-Vietnamese war. You see, China had this very stale military doctrine at this point where they believed that there was a military structure at platoon level where you had riflemen and you had submachine gunners and you had basically World War II.
When was this?
This was like in the early 80s, I want to say, late 70s.
1979.
I don't think we're going to war.
My dad was in like Vietnam proper.
No, the Chinese were using like majorly like SKS rifles still, while the Viet Cong had like AKs and M16s.
Bro, I don't care about the weaponry, bro. The Vietnamese, from what my dad told me, the Vietnamese are fucking ruthless. Like he said that he was in a bar. This is the only story. Like my dad was born in 1946, so I can't do the math right now, but he'd almost be 80. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
If he were still alive. But the one story that he told me that really stuck out to me was that he was in a bar in the jungle that fucking like civilians made out of spare beer cans, and a bunch of fucking GIs were in there, and a little girl who he said was hypnotized came in with a live grenade and pulled a pin. And everybody just started bursting out of the fucking beer can bar. And what? I've imagined this many a time. Like, you know, like the South Park when they're talking about the fucking like water slides in Vietnam and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like when you hear these stories, my dad, I don't believe my dad was a liar because he said this shit like with true. It's the only thing he said multiple times, like the hypnotized little Vietnamese girl, fucking grenade in the beer can bar. But it's like so absurd to me that the fucking Vietnamese were like building beer can bars in the jungle.
I've heard of those though. I've heard this story.
I've heard of that too. They build bars out of any like random junk I've heard in like deep rural Vietnam.
And yeah, he said she was hypnotized. I think she, you know, brainwashed, you know, like regular extremist child. Like you would any fucking extremist child, you know? Like children are pretty easy to brainwash. You give them a gun, you know? You give a child a gun, they're pretty fucking dangerous, you know?
But my point was, like, China had, like, bad tactics, and that's why, like, Vietnam easily just kind of fucked them up.
I think that I am terrified of Asians, and which is crazy. My wife's stepdad's Filipino, so, like, you know, I got a lot of Asian influence in my life currently.
The girl I'm talking to right now is like an eighth Japanese, so
god damn it.
Oh no, boy, please.
God no. Okay, Yakov.
Yakov, we got an issue.
What are you nerds talking about?
It changed really quick. It dramatically changed to an Asian female. Allegedly.
Now he's talking to a Japanese woman.
Oh, god damn it.
God. This is what we're doing.
No, I didn't want to do this. I didn't ask for this. I was talking about hypnotized Vietnamese children. Like, god damn it.
If anybody has any advice for getting Polak laid, email it to yakovalive@protonmail.com and I'll send it to Polak. See if he takes it. I don't know.
Yeah, bro, email it to redacted@redacted.com.
Fucking turn. Frankly, if anybody out there has anything to fucking any input whatsoever, if you want to fucking come on a panel, whatever the fuck, yakovalive@protonmail.com. If you got a spooky story you want to relay, whatever you got, hit me up.
If you have ever killed a hooer, you probably shouldn't broadcast it to internet, honestly. Keep that to yourself.
What the hell should we play as outro music?
The soundtrack to
somebody put something on. Whoever puts on the spookiest music first is the winner.
Yeah, something spooky. Something
get
spooky.
Get the shitty synthesizer music from Schizophrenic.
Yeah, we can just listen to that repeat forever, dude.
The Skyrim dungeon music.
How long have we been going? Almost 4 hours at this point. Yeah. Maybe not quite that much. Yeah, like over three and a half. I think we've given the people their money's worth on this Halloween. I like to go long on Halloween. That's the only tradition. I don't really need anything else. I'd go long on Halloween. Right. And I am pretty fucking drunk at this point.
Pretty fucked up.
How you guys feeling? And honestly, like the drunken content, like it's sad how well alcohol lubricates this whole thing. Because like last week we did a drunk show where Jack, you like showed up drunk, and I like gradually got drunk, and it was great. And it's like,
Can I just tell you?
Thanks,
guys,
alcohol.
From the bottom of my heart, fucking Cloaca.
I'll grab another beer.
Ah. Delicious.
This is LaCroix mixed with
Did I? I think I fucking muted the bot. That's the problem we're having right now.
You did.
Yeah. That's.
Oh no, that's not what I wanted.
This is what we got, brother. This is the spookiest thing you've ever heard in your life. Chicken wang.
I was putting on a Charlie Brown theme song.
Why did you put on the Benny Hill theme? Someone put something spooky on. Right? Slash skip. Come on, we're going to stick around until someone gets something spooky on the goddamn airwaves here.
Should I play some, like, Witch House? What do you mean?
Dude, Witch House is, like, the most default answer I can fucking imagine. But that's my problem. That's why I said it, because I didn't want to be the one who puts on Witch House.
Play some horror scent.
Find some horror fucking OST. I don't fucking know. We need something spooky to go out on.
What is this?
The hell is this? Witch House? Ooh, that's Witch House, baby. Is it gonna sound like bees? You know it's Witch House because it sounds like a lot of bees.
Like, you know, bees, bro. It's a fucking apiary. Wait.
There it is. Bees. You can hear the bees.
They are.
Hell yeah.
Bees.
Yep, we love our Witch House here. Thank you very much for joining us on this Halloween evening. It is Halloween evening, after all. I wish you much candy. Trunk or treating, that's something I could bitch about every year going forward in Halloween forever.
It's ruined. There's nobody who fucking does trick or treating anymore. Nobody fucking gives out candy.
Nobody does it in my little area either.
Here's the real shit, dude. I'll buy, like, some candy because, like, I gotta have the candy. What if there are trick or treaters? I have to have candy. But then it's like I eat half the candy and then, like, fuck, I guess I gotta buy another fucking bag of candy because what if there are trick or treaters? I'm eating all of the candy. I gotta stop lying to myself about it. And dude, the best thing about Halloween when I was a kid was walking around the fucking neighborhood, like, when it was fucking night with your homies and, like, nobody around to tell you what to do. You're all in crazy costumes. You all got a bunch of, you're hopped up on sugar and you're with your homies walking around. That was the best part.
Hell yeah.
That's why I would extend it. Like, we bought fucking Kmart masks when we were, like, 14 just so we could go door to door as fucking teenagers. Like, we were just in, like, Slipknot shirts and fucking Kmart demon masks. You know what I mean? And, like, nowadays, like, you can't go door to door. My son, I have to go to, like, the mall. It's the
awful.
Worst thing in the world.
Are we still streaming?
Yeah, I'm about to wrap it up right now. Thank you once again, everyone, joining us. Don't be trunk or treating with your kids. Make them just walk around alone in the neighborhood, dude. Send them out to the world.
Just toddle around to the neighborhood by themselves.
Hit me up, people. You know where to get at.
Give the razor blade candy.
Whoop, the acid razor blade candy, dude.
Acid razor blade candy.
Never check your kids' candy. That's what fucking shit.
I test all my kids. I have to eat all of my kids' candy to make sure there's no acid or razor blades on it.
I went to. That was like
I ran into stream. I'm not letting Senor go on another tangent. I'm sorry. I know the people out there are dying from more Senor tangents. End in stream. Thank you.